fall, this ABC Sports exclusive brought to you by Geo. Get to know Geo, available right around the corner at your Chevrolet Geo dealers. By UPS, offering 10:30 a.m. guaranteed overnight air delivery. And by Delta Airlines, we love to fly and it shows.
Mark Jones and Tim Brandt back in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. A great day for a football game, Tim. 90 degrees at game time. And as we look at the series record, Death Valley has been exactly that for Texas A&M. The last three times here, they have lost.
Interesting already. LSU wins the toss but defers and elects the kickoff. They want to set the tempo of this game with their defense.
Pedro Suarez, an all-SEC pick in 1991, will kick it off for the Tigers. And back deep for Texas A&M, it'll be Ray Mickens and Billy Mitchell. And the kick is out of bounds at about the 7-yard line. Suarez's kick going off to the right. And it looks like Texas A&M will take over.
Dick Burleson, the referee today. A couple things to look for early. A&M and Granger need success early. There he is right there. No turnovers last week, but he did struggle.
Granger, 11 of 31 last week, 132 yards and one touchdown, but he did not perform well. A look at the backs and the receivers. Greg the Thrill Hill, the sophomore from Dallas Carter High School. He can do it all. First down at the 35. Little play action. Granger completes his first pass down to the 42-yard line.
James McKeon, the tight end, slipped out. They flooded the area. It looks like LSU right away is going to load up and challenge him to run. They did it with their safety moving him up like a linebacker. Granger came right out and threw, and there's the early success we talked about. Last week he missed the pass with a wide-open guy at the top.
Up front, Dexter Wesley is the guy to watch. They'll run over the left side quite a bit. And John Elliser is also a leader up front on that Texas A&M offensive line. 22-yard pickup for Granger on his first toss of the game. Back to pass again to Carter. And Carter is brought down at the 40-yard line. Let's have a look at the defense now for LSU. They'll set up in a 3-4. Clayton Mouton is one of the leaders up front. He's 6'2", 277 pounds. He is a senior, makes big plays. Of the linebackers, Ricardo Washington is a fantastic athlete. He'll make some big plays. Second down and 7 to go. Two tight ends in for A&M. A quick hitter to the tight end, and it's complete down to the 25. Pardon me, that's Ryan Matthews. A pickup of 15 yards, and A&M comes out gunning.
Well, and it's a good strategy, too. They knew that A&M, having watched the Stanford game, would load up 8 and 9 guys. You see them? They're cheating even their secondary up in the linebacker spots. Just quick opener out to Matthews on the quick slant. He pops into the seam right there. It was zone coverage, and he picks up 15.
Hill and Carter in the offset eye. Matthews wide to the bottom of the screen. Granger fumbles it and gets it to Hill. Boy, when you're good, you're lucky.
I'm not so sure he got it to Hill. I think Hill just picked that thing off in midair. Now, Granger, as we said, we don't want to beat this thing down, but he really did bruise his confidence against Stanford. Comes out now. He's 3 for 3, 40 yards. Now he can work Hill into the offense. Now he's already loosened up the LSU defense with those passes, and now he can work Hill in and get the running game going.
Try and get LSU out of that 8-man front that Texas A&M was expecting coming into this one. Second down and 2. Hand off to Hill. Yeah, it's Greg Hill time. Down to the 8-yard line and a first down.
A&M marching from a drive that started from their own 35-yard line. Revelro Swan making the tackle that time for LSU.
A&M's offensive line came into this season. Some of the experts said it was one of the best in the country. Then they struggled last week, and everybody said, look, this offensive line is overrated. I think they're coming out here on this first drive in an effort to prove that they are solid.
Handed off to the fullback, Carter, and he's down to the six, a pickup of about 3.5 yards. Carter, 6 feet, 216 pounds. He's a senior.
Not only is he a senior, he's an old man. He's been around 6 years, had a knee problem, so he had the NCAA give him some leeway there. He's come back 6 years now he's playing.
R.C. Slocum. Players talk about him as being a real player's coach, just one of the guys. Very approachable, very easygoing. And he'll be even more easygoing if they can stick this into the end zone. Handoff to Carter, inside handoff, and he's down to the one. Carter again had a tough time last week hanging on to the ball out of the backfield, but this time running the ball strongly, Tim.
He shouldn't have gone this far. Watch 96, Bo Davis has him, makes a hit, boom, right there. He gets out of that. There he is, 216 pounds. He's got that low center of gravity, and he bangs his way down to the one, but Bo Davis missed the tackle.
The opening drive by Texas A&M, starting at the 35, now on the one-yard line. Two tight ends in the jumbo package. Granger, wide open. Bootleg touchdown, Carter.
Wide open.
Texas A&M takes it in the house on their first possession. Just finished saying that Carter had trouble hanging on to the ball last week against Stanford, but this time he squeezed it for the one-yard touchdown reception.
Well, in all fairness, he was sick last week before the game, and I think that caused problems.
Terry Venetoulias for the extra point. And in under 4 minutes, the Aggies put 7 points on the board, going 8 plays, 65 yards. Hey, there's more to come.
These extinct relics of American business remind us that waste and inefficiency don't pay. And that while perhaps it used to be impressive to throw money around, today it's more impressive not to. A timely reminder from the only company that guarantees 10:30 overnight delivery for up to 40% less, UPS.
He's got the auto lights.
American or import, we're guaranteed.
2 years, no matter how far he goes.
That's why we've been everywhere. Wow!
For new vehicle quality, Chevrolet is the best full-size pickup. That's a quote from J.D. Power & Associates, one of the most authoritative research companies in the automotive business. Chevrolet is the best full-size pickup. The highest initial quality in its class. Only Chevrolet. The trucks you can depend on. The trucks that last.
Imagine a rent-a-car company that offers special delivery right to your door. That's Enterprise.
Here, let me help you.
Enterprise. A special rent-a-car company that gives you special delivery.
Number one, Miami, defends their national title against Big Ten power Iowa. Tonight on ABC Sports.
The best is here.
David Butler and Garrett McGee.
Back in Baton Rouge, 7-0 as Texas A&M rams it down LSU's throat in the opening possession of the ballgame.
One of the great traditions at Texas A&M, Trent Bishop right there, number 12. He's the 12th man, just a student that they put on the kickoff team.
Back deep, it's David Butler and Gary Pegues, and Butler says, I don't think so. They take the touchback, and the Tigers will start off on their own 20-yard line.
Boy, Boy, it did not take A&M long. They moved down eight plays, 65 yards. Took just 3.5 minutes. Watch Granger sucks everybody in with the play action. There goes his fullback to the left of the screen, 32. That's Doug Carter. His brother's Michael with the 49ers football family. One of the most underrated players in the country makes the touchdown catch, and just like that, bang, A&M up on top.
Good ball handling by Granger, too, that time. Now it's LSU's turn. Chad Lupe at quarterback on the option to Robert Davis. What a move by the freshman. Hey, he's ready to show you something. Chad Lupe, the starting quarterback, 6'2", 206-pound junior. Last year, he started six games. Jesse Daigle started the other five. The type of guy that the coach says will not beat you. Make smart decisions. In the backfield, Robert Davis, the freshman, Mr. Alabama football, last year in high school. And up front, Kevin Mawai is an all-SEC pick. A pickup of eight on first down. Here's Davis again. Not as lucky the second time. He stopped up at the 27-yard line. Tackled by Sam Adams.
Robert Davis carry.
A great Texas A&M defense. What else is new? This is the linebacker U of the South. Sam Adams, last year's newcomer of the year in the conference. Marcus Buckley, both say, will be a first-round pick in the National Football League. In the secondary, Aaron Glenn had an interception last week, and Patrick Bates, a big, strong safety that can hit. Third down and two. Loop to pass. Completes it to Odell Beckham to the far side of the field, and they have their first down of 1992.
Now, see, there's one of the surprises we talked about. Odell Beckham was a tailback last year. As a matter of fact, he was the starting tailback, ran for 400 yards, 5 yards a carry. Now they put him in at fullback because of Davis. They bring him out of the backfield. A&M's not expecting this, and then he gets it on his fingertips, bobbles it up, says, hey, here it is, first down. Man, I'm playing fullback today. Here's Curley.
Curley Holman, 5-6 last year, was worried about this game. Wasn't sure how the team would come out with all the young players. But Davis making another statement here, out to the 43-yard line.
You think Curley Holman wouldn't like to win this game? There's a former A&M defensive back. Now he's coaching against him.
Now this game does have special meaning for him.
He played there in 66, 67, 68 as a defensive back. Robert Davis, highly recruited, not a great speed guy, but he does make people miss him. Stop and start, hide and seek guy behind the big offensive lineman.
Picked up five on first down. Besh in motion. The give is to the fullback, Beckham, who eludes one tackler, and is out to the 47. Nice looking run.
Yeah, it is. That's a nice system, too, to put him in at fullback, because now it gives you an extra added weapon.
Odell Beckham last year was the leading rusher on this team.
What he does is he gives quickness and depth to this offense.
But Curley Holman said we will see at least six backs rotating in and out of that LSU backfield. Tigers come out in the offset eye. He hands it off to Davis. Making the freshman work a little bit over midfield to the 48. Pickup of about 4 yards. It'll be second and six.
Graham and Solari.
Stopped that time by Steve Solari.
Donnie McKeehan.
9:03 remaining in the first quarter. It's 7-0.
6-1.
I don't think Curley Holman, Tim, wanted to see Texas A&M come out and score on their first possession.
Should be a flag.
Whistle on the play.
Ball setters, the right tackle jumped.
Flag on the play.
For LSU. Just lifted up.
It's against the offense.
Let me translate what Dick Burleson just said. Read lips. He says it's against LSU, 65, setters, right tackle.
Setters a junior. That offensive line has a lot of athletic ability, one of the strong points up front. And Curley was saying that he might try rotating the offensive units.
Jesse Daigle just came into the game, last year's starting quarterback. He's in as a receiver. If I'm on defense, I think look out for him. He could throw something.
He's in the slot to the left of Luke.
but it's a handoff to Beckham.
Beckham is over midfield to the 49, stopped by Steve Solari. Solari, 6'1", 225-pound junior, had a strong performance against Stanford last week. He's a transfer from Purdue.
This is the number one defense in the country. It's a club that's very, very aggressive, and yet you look at some of the blocks the guys are catching. Teichelman, 58, got pushed out of the way. You see Buckley right there. He's had swelling in his joints, and has not really practiced much. They say he's about 75%, but he's an outstanding player.
Him at 75 is as good as anyone at 100. Luke, he's got a man open. Wesley Jacob, incomplete at the 35. So the Tigers will have to punt it away.
Boy, the sad part of that is he was wide open. The ball was thrown poorly. He had to readjust, but still could have made the catch.
Into punt, Brian DeSales, who won the job as a walk-on in the spring.
Eric Fraser
is back deep for the Aggies. Nice high kick. Fraser's going to let it bounce. And they can't get there in time. A 49-yard punt into the end zone. The Aggies, with their second possession, will start off on their 20. Stick around. We'll be back.
I drove literally every car in the same class. It boiled down to, I wanted a Geo Storm.
Guys like a girl that knows how to drive a stick.
There's 140 horses in here. Can you, hello? Horses.
The cockpit's laid out like a jet.
You don't have to be a race car driver to drive a Storm, but you sure feel like one.
If this car had wings, it would fly.
Now's the time to get to know Geo Storm, right around the corner at your Chevrolet Geo dealers.
No better way to face the day.
The morning belongs to SpeedStick. It's 110% protection against wetness and odor that lasts all day. Start the morning with SpeedStick, the wide stick, for powerful 24-hour protection.
And it's no better way to face the day. No better way to face the day.
SpeedStick, 110% protection.
Tony and Diane get regular insurance checkups, just like they get regular medical checkups. I'm State Farm Agent Carlos Bermudez. I have been their State Farm Agent 7 years. A family insurance checkup helps them make sure all their coverages are up to date. It's also a good time to explore options, like how their life insurance plan can be adapted to help with their daughter's college education. I think the family insurance checkup is something everybody can feel good about.
State Farm is there.
While Hurricane Andrew caused $1 billion worth of damage in the state of Louisiana, most hard hit was the Gulf Coast area, and here's a look at some of the damage caused here in Baton Rouge. Lots of downed trees, roofs coming off of homes. Even the campus was touched by the worst disaster in American history. The roof of the baseball stadium coming off there.
Hurricane Andrew blew reality and tragedy through the South. Certainly put football in perspective.
And it sure did.
Rearranged our priorities.
If you'd like to make a donation to the relief fund, this is the American Red Cross disaster relief number, 1-800-842-2200. And you can't think for a minute that this didn't have a profound effect on the LSU Tigers. Carter and Hill in the backfield, lined up in the eye for A&M. Granger hands it off to Greg Hill, slips outside. Boy, he's got nice feet.
Forward right up out of his free safety spot to make that tackle. I will tell you this, LSU needs some defensive success. That play right there is really the first time they've stopped A&M on a play thus far without positive yardage, big yardage. Although they still get five, but they've got to have some success. They've got to force a turnover. Right now, Granger, the pitcher, is tossing a perfect game. He's 4-for-4.
Unlike last week against Stanford, where he was stone cold, he fumbles the snap from center. And he pounces on it at the 23.
See, this is what LSU needs in the heat of Tiger Stadium. Look at this, 90 degrees. And they've got some guys going both ways.
Oh, boy.
We're working up a lather up here in the booth, too. Look at this. A&M puts in Hill and Thomas, the two tailbacks, in the ballgame at the same time.
They're split behind Granger on 3rd and 8. Looking to the near side. Nobody open. And it's almost intercepted. Robert Deschotel had it in his hands and dropped it. Corey White also had a piece, Tim.
Corey White hit it first. Deschotel came. He tipped it, and then White almost got it back. That's the success we were telling you they needed.
Got to get this crowd into the ballgame.
No question about it.
David Davis punted the ball until his leg fell off last week against Stanford 13 times. But put up some good numbers, averaged over 43 yards a punt. Carlton Buckles is back deep.
All right, after the successful defensive stand, now you've got to have discipline on the return team. Don't be off sides, don't block, don't rough the kicker, don't fumble, don't clip.
Well, they stand to get good field position after this punt. Get a whistle down on the field. Try and figure out what that's all about. Well, Curly Hallman was saying, Tim, that he just knows his players and his staff a lot better this year. Feels a lot more comfortable than he did at the same time last season.
Well, he's trying desperately to turn this thing around. You know, he was 8 years old the last time LSU had three straight losing seasons. He wants to get a winning season back on the ledger.
Davis, 9-yard line. Strong rush, but he gets it off. This is a returnable punt. There's Buckles. And there's going to be a clip called against LSU as Buckles takes it out to the 45-yard line.
See, what did we just talk about? The four don'ts of the kicking game. Don't clip. Don't let the ball hit the ground. Don't be sides and don't rough the kicker.
It's a 45-yard punt. And Buckles ran it back 11 yards. Well, they'll push this one back further.
It'll be a push in the back.
The clip may have been against Gary Pegues.
Push in the back. Illegal.
Here's another look.
Watch to the left of your screen right there. Cannot do it. Pegues, offensive player. He's got to know better than that.
So they will march this one back.
Better to let that guy go and have a shot. Hope the ball return guy can give him a move rather than clipping.
LSU is still looking for some early success with 6-13 remaining here in the first quarter. If you look at the record in home openers, not too bad. 10-3 against A&M. David Butler now in along with Jermaine Williams in the backfield. This is Butler, another freshman. Spins off one man down to the 38-yard line. Eric England, the nose guard, making the tackle for Texas A&M.
David Butler, carry.
David Butler, 5'9", 185 pounds. He is a freshman. I'll
tell you this, though. He did show some inexperience here. Once he got past the first wave, then he had Simnick, the right guard, in front of him. He cut left into the tackler. Had he gone right, it was wide open.
That's why they call them freshmen, right?
Is that what that means?
Means the coach will cut you a little slack once in a while. Then he'll cut you loose. Williams will stay in the ballgame, and Jay Johnson, another freshman from Waco, Texas, will check in.
You know, it's scary sitting here watching Texas A&M. Number one defense in the country, 56 sacks last year, and you look at their depth chart, there's only three seniors on the defensive 2D. As a matter of fact, this season started in College Station with 60 freshmen or sophomores.
Now, Texas A&M, Tim, their program is almost at the stage now where it recruits itself. They're almost at that elite level.
I picked them to be part of the national championship. I think their schedule is very conducive to that.
I'll check in with you at the end of the season on that, too.
You would.
5:40 remaining in the first quarter. Butler back in the game. Luke rolling out. Completes the pass to Besh. The walk-on with a first down. Up to the 46-yard line. A pickup of 17 yards. The tackle that time made by Aaron Glenn.
Brent Besh is a great story. He's a walk-on two-year guy, but Luke makes this play. Watch him rolls. All of a sudden, Besh comes clear, and he just gets it out there quickly. nothing fancy about it. They just beat the DB on that play and beat him to the flats. But there he is, Brett Best, 6'1", 174 pounds, walk-on, two-year player.
He's going in motion now to the top of your screen. That's in the eye, and Luke with a mix-up on the option toss to Butler. And Butler picks up a few yards. And maybe a late hit on the sideline, but no flag.
No, that's what the crowd wants, but he really couldn't help it. Glenn had him on his shoulder. He just didn't put him down gently.
Well, they're not really friends, right? We'd now like to pause 5 seconds to allow our ABC stations to identify themselves.
Christy Phillips, Olympic gymnast, now a cheerleader here at LSU.
Double duty. That's in the eye. Handoff down to the 37. That's Butler again. And he's stacked up by Teichelman and Jason Atkinson. Jason Atkinson, one of the strongest players on this Texas A&M team. He was their leading tackler last year.
Yeah, he's an atom splitter, too. He's a guy who excels in school. He's a civil engineer. Power cleans 350 pounds like you do.
Oh, yes. Gotta hang with him at the gym. Approaching 5 minutes remaining in the first quarter. LSU still not on the scoreboard. A toss to Butler. And there you see some of that Texas A&M speed, Tim. Getting to the ball, making the play.
Yeah, big play by Sam Adams. Eric England got there as well. The linebackers filled. They're big, they're strong, they're fast. You know, A&M's got perhaps the most patriotic line I've ever seen with Sam Adams. They had Patrick Henry. They got England. But you see here, he comes through. Adams goes. He gets there first, and then all the support comes.
They can watch a football game and get a history lesson at the same time, huh?
And another flag against LSU.
Well, they really moved the ball fairly well in the early stages of the game here, but they haven't had any payoff.
Well, we keep talking about all the freshmen that Curley Holman is playing. There he is right there. And I'm one who believes that the true freshman is threatening to replace the fifth-year senior in the NCAA. With so many kids leaving early, the pros, coaches are forced to put more emphasis on youth.
There's the call from the official. This is a hold against LSU.
All right, so they'll move it back 10. It'll bring up first down and 20.
After the first down. Williams and Beckham in the offset eye. Behind Luke. Looking to pass. Runs it now down to the 42-yard line. Busy day in college football. John Saunders with an update in New York.
Thanks, Mark. Notre Dame and Northwestern. Rick Meyer here with a little play action to Oscar McBride. 5 yards for the touchdown. He's now just 14 days away from Joe Theismann's school record. Back to Mark and Tim.
All right, John. Joe Theismann, guy that played in your part of the woods, up in Washington.
Played with the Washington Redskins, still lives in Northern Virginia.
Jesse Daigle in at receiver. He's in the slot. Off to the right of Chad Luke. And a whistle on the field. May have been too much time.
It's a delay of game. See, now what happens here is, we've talked about the youth, we've talked about Texas A&M. A&M has no penalties. LSU, playing its first game of the year, has four.
And they'll march it off again against the Tigers.
Somehow they've got to get in this ball game. Chad Luke knows it, but they can't go after the big play. They've just got to make this thing come and come, and they've got to let the big play come to them. It's got to be a fumble, an interception, maybe a receiver breaking loose.
They've had the freshman tailbacks in and out of the ball game, both Butler and Robert Davis. They run the ball pretty well, something they did not do last year.
See if they don't bring Marcus Buckley on the blitz this time, Texas A&M.
Luke passing. And he's got Scott Ray at the 37-yard line. So Luke finds his man, and they get some of the yardage back. A 12-yard pickup by Scott Ray.
Interesting that A&M had LSU backing up. So instead of really being aggressive and causing some commotion here, they go into a zone. Watch, Buckley's in on this tackle because he's back in the hook zone, back in the flat. See number 9 right there? So they get a big chunk of it. They get 12. And now, at least they've got a shot at the first.
It's 3rd and 10. Leslie Jacob is split wide to the top of your screen. Jermaine Williams is in the backfield. A blitz. Luke gets away temporarily. Down to the 40-yard line. This Texas A&M team can put defensive pressure on you. Jason Atkinson making the tackle. Last year, they had 56 sacks.
Well, Lance Teichelman was there as well. He had 6 tackles behind the line of scrimmage last year, and he came very, very aggressively on the blitz. He got support from the linebackers, and Teichelman's a defensive tackle. But when you get the linebackers coming as well, you outman them, and somebody comes free.
Got to count up and match up. Couldn't do it that time. Sellers into punt, standing on his 47. Nice kick. Nice punt. They have a chance to down this. And they do at the 6-yard line. A 34-yard punt. We'll be back after you give us this break.
He's in Manhattan on Wednesday, Frankfurt on Thursday, Paris, Rome, and Vienna after that. He believes it's better to do business across a table than over a fax machine. This year, he'll fly more than 100,000 miles with us. Because he knows nobody understands him better than we do. At Delta, when we say we love to fly and it shows, this is where it shows.
Maybe your first car shouldn't be a car.
I was 18, didn't have a care, working for peanuts, not a dime to spare.
Get this Chevy S10 EL pickup with cash back for around $8,000. Chevrolet, the trucks you can depend on, the trucks that last.
You ought to try a new KFC popcorn chicken. Bite-sized morsels of tender, crispy chicken. Delicious. I call them the Colonel's Colonels. Get it?
New KFC popcorn chicken. A fun deal in Lake Edna or your neck of the woods.
A recent Department of Energy study reveals that most American homes are under-insulated. And that means you. To find out what's right for your home, call Owens Corning at 1-800-GET-PINK.
Oh, okay. What are you going to give me? 5'7"? The score is 7-0, 2:53 remaining in the first quarter. LSU still not on the scoreboard. And Jeff Granger has been a different Jeff Granger as compared to last week against Stanford.
4 for 5, playing with confidence.
Backs line up in the eye, Carter and Hill. It's Greg Hill time. And Greg Hill time means he's out to the 13-yard line.
I'm telling you, folks, this offensive line is just blowing LSU off of there. Wesley, Harrison, Ellison and Mathewson, Dawson in the middle. Great fire out.
Defensive coordinator Mike Booger trying to figure something out. Trying to stop the surge by that offensive line. A different offensive line, Tim, so far as compared to last week. Do you think Bob Toledo got in their face a little bit?
Well, I don't think there's any question about it. Right now, they're dominating.
A handoff to Carter this time, and he's stopped up. May have gotten a yard. They set up 3rd down and 3. David Walk up in on the tackle that time, the 6'2", 222-pound senior.
Bo Davis, Anthony Williams.
Got an assist from Bo Davis.
You know, LSU defensively last year gave up 385 yards a game. Only Kentucky gave up more in the conference.
Most of that, Tim, against the run, too.
Well, there's no question. Teams average an incredible 49 running plays a game.
Big play here if LSU can pin Texas A&M in their own zone here.
Ranger hands it off to Hill, and Hill will have the first down. He's a money runner, and he paid off that time.
Well, tomorrow on ABC Sports, the big guns of the PGA Tour will be shooting for the title. Join us at 4 Eastern, 3 Central, and Pacific for final round coverage of the Greater Milwaukee Open presented by Sharps tomorrow on ABC Sports.
Right now, Hill has 5 carries, 30 yards. Texas A&M playing smash-mouth football.
And LSU with a couple bloody nose. This is Carter. Up to the 23, David Walker been on the tackle.
Rivero Swan with the tackle. He's big time, 6'2", 225. Walkup was there again as well.
Bob Toledo expected this 8-man front from LSU. Also said he wanted to try and come out and throw to the backs and the receivers.
But it's really not an 8-man front. It's making it look like that. They're using a stem look like an Eagle defense, but really they're just bringing up their secondary.
Second down and 7. Ranger, 3-step drop, and it's batted down at the line of scrimmage. Corey White, all 6'3 of them, got those big paws up and batted it down.
You know, that's the second time White has batted a pass down. He has really improved, and the coaches said he had to improve. They told him.
Well, if he keeps it up, he could be in line for the Chevrolet Player of the Game Award at the conclusion of today's game. He'll be selecting a Chevy Most Valuable Player of the Game from each team. And for the 22nd year through the Chevrolet Scholarship Program, $1,000 will be donated to the General Scholarship Fund of each school. Downfield incomplete. Intended for the tight end, Greg Short. A big target, but Granger couldn't find him.
And it was poorly thrown. If you can get Granger thinking like he was against Stanford in that first game, a little bit unnerved, starting to throw like a baseball pitcher rather than a quarterback and stepping in and dragging a foot, LSU could have a shot defensively.
Yeah, Tim, his feet, he doesn't seem to have happy feet so far in this game. Not facing quite as much pressure as he did against Stanford. Carlton Buckles back deep, Davis punting, his second of the afternoon. Buckles on the 40. Looking for a seam, didn't find one. He got out to the 43. Let's go to New York and John Saunders with the scoring update. John?
Northwestern on the move here against the Fighting Irish. And watch the nifty little fake. They give it to Lee Gissendaner, who goes 14 yards, takes it into the end zone for the touchdown, and Northwestern's tied with the Irish. Mark Jones.
All right, John, what about the problems of Notre Dame? It seems like every year to start the season, something seems to come up. This year it's Demetrius DeBose.
Luke, play action, going downtown.
And he couldn't find Shedrick Wilson, overthrown, but had his man wide open.
Boy, I tell you that, he was wide open. Nobody picked Wilson up out of the backfield. Luke knows it, too. That could be a little bit too much adrenaline flow. He's got to get a couple high percentage passes and hit them. Watch Wilson, 41. Now, here's a guy that comes out of Thomasville, Georgia. Boy, what a tradition they have down at Thomasville High. Remember Sean Jones, a quarterback at Georgia Tech, and William Andrews?
Mike Jones.
All played down there, that's right.
Second down and 10 after the incomplete pass. Luke rolling out. Tucks it under and got smacked at the 45. Jason Atkinson lowered the boom on Chad Loop. And that will be the last play of the first quarter here in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. The score, 7-0.
That's the end of the first period.
Getting to know you, getting to know all about you.
More than a million of you have gotten to know Geo. In fact, Geo's the most successful new line of cars and trucks ever introduced. So for the millionth time, get to know Geo. Geo Metro, Geo Storm, Geo Tracker, and coming soon, the newest Geo, Geo Prism, at your Chevrolet Geo dealers.
Getting to know.
Did you tell your boss you're quitting?
No, I'm telling him on Monday.
Got any plans yet?
A few.
No celebrity spokesman.
I'm opening a restaurant.
No beach volleyball games.
How about another Heineken?
No lengthy description of the brewing process.
None of that is what made Heineken the number one imported beer in America.
You got that steady paycheck?
Oh, yeah. I got a few bucks put away.
So you want to own a restaurant?
No, what I really want to do is be a relief pitcher.
Our fifth anniversary, and they call right in the middle of dinner.
Oh.
You know, I got one of those calls trying to get me to change from AT&T
to MCI.
And guess who gave them my number? Hey, they said.
Dave.
You put them on to me, too, about this friends and family thing.
Yeah.
What are you guys talking about, Dave, giving out your numbers?
That's
what
you did.
At AT&T, your friends are your business. Keeping you connected to them is ours.
Dave, what? You know anything about this friends and family thing?
Trust me.
It's just not worth it.
It's the lifeblood of your engine. That makes your oil filter your engine's most vital organ. That's why Fram keeps going the extra mile to make the best protection even better. The Fram Extra Guard Oil Filter. Unique glass fiber paper stops more dirt than any other filter for the best protection ever. Fram Extra Guard. American or import, it's an extra lease on life.
Just a reminder that kids who participate in high school sports tend to go a little farther than those who don't.
After the first quarter, the statistics are pretty much even.
No question. Look at the first downs, four apiece. Look at the total yards, 84, and that should be 83. And so that's how close it is. And 65 of those 84 yards for A&M came in that first drive. The difference thus far in this game, three penalties early on. I think they have a total of four penalties now.
Yeah, Tim, surprising too, also on the statistic sheet, no turnovers by either team, and both teams are pretty young, so not too bad in that respect. Three wide receivers in for the Tigers now, Beckham in the backfield. And a whistle on the field.
You know, I've got to wonder what's going on in that offensive line, because that time it was Madden who moved at right guard, or right tackle rather. There he is, 6'3", 278 pounds. He's had knee problems, but he's got to be disciplined. Watch the left side of your screen. Second guy in. See him moving? That's Madden. He cannot do that. That's discipline. You got to wait, wait, wait.
And the officials caught him. Ball back on the 41 now. Third down and 12 for the Tigers. Luke going to Shedrick Wilson again, but incomplete at the 30. Well covered that time. Let's go to New York and John Saunders.
Louisville and Ohio State, what a finish. 33 seconds left in the game, 20-19, the Buckeyes with the lead. Louisville going for the win on the two-point conversion, but the toss from Brohm falls short of Dawkins. They lose by one.
It's in for the Tigers.
The second year in a row, it's come down to the last play. They've gone to win it, and they lose it.
I hear a heart pounding from Columbus, Ohio. I think it's John Cooper's. Brian DeSellis into punt, standing on his 29. This is Derek Fraser. Fraser up the middle. Oh! Tiptoes his way out to the 40. 33-yard punt, 14 on the return. We got a good ball game. 14:45 remaining in the second quarter.
Frazier has returned the punt. Tackled by Walker.
My son to daycare every day, and his security is my primary concern.
Paul Kewin talks about his new Goodyear AquaTread radials.
When I first saw the AquaTread, I thought, okay, I see how the water is going to flow away.
The advanced deep groove aqua channel channels water away as you drive.
I feel like I've got control in different conditions.
AquaTread, only from Goodyear. Paul Kewin knows, and it's why we say the best tires in the world have Goodyear written all over them.
I feel very confident.
Chevy S10 Blazer, we can promise you the sun, the moon, and the stars. We can also promise you $2,000 cash back. Chevy S10 Blazer.
reminder from Walmart. No matter who you are, no matter what you drive, there's one sure way to get more out of it. Regular oil changes with quality Havoline motor oil. When you add Havoline, you add more life to your car. And with Walmart savings every day of the year, you're not only miles ahead, you're dollars ahead too. Saving money at Walmart. It's an idea that's really catching on. Walmart. Always the low price. Always.
Texas tackles Syracuse. Tennessee takes on Georgia, plus other regional action next Saturday on ABC's College Football.
Well, you're looking at maybe the most courageous person in the entire stadium right now, Donovan Cook. Tell you about his story in a minute after this run. This is Greg Hill out to the 33-yard line, but Donovan Cook is a fine young man, a brave young man here from Louisiana. He's battling cancer right now. He's in remission, and his story has been so inspirational that Curly Holman, the head coach, has made him an honorary captain.
And what number is he wearing?
Number one.
Number one.
He's the man. Second down and six for the Bayou Bengals. Pardon me, for Texas A&M. Hill and Carter in the backfield. Under pressure, finds Carter out of the backfield. Nice grab into LSU territory at the 41. Nice looking delivery that time, Tim, by that man right there.
And a saving tackle, too. I'll tell you this. Watch McCorvey make this tackle or he's gone. Granger started out 4-for-4, then missed 3 in a row, still came back and drilled this on the slant in the zone, and McCorvey has to dive to stop him. There's not another soul to his left between the goal line and where he is right there.
A pickup of 16 yards and a first down. Granger to pass again, had Carter, almost intercepted by McCorvey. Man, they could have used that. Right in his hands.
Three times, LSU defensive players have had the ball in their hands and they've dropped it.
Texas A&M obviously trying to hit their backs out of the backfield.
Can't expect to win a game if you can't make the big play. They've had every opportunity. Boy, that guy right there, Jeff Granger, I think he's living the good life. Five quarters now, A&M's gone without a turnover.
Pretty good for a young team, too. Then lines up to the left-hand side. Play action. Off of the helmet of Ricardo Washington, he tried to go back to Carter again. But Carter was not open. Washington had a blanket on him. Ricardo Washington, 6'4", 224-pound junior, and runs well, too.
Well, Washington was beaten, in all honesty. He's got to take that man. That was his man coming out of the backfield. He's got to read his first step, see if he's going to be a ball carrier or a receiver. Once you determine he's a receiver, you've got to stay in his hip pocket. And it wasn't the case. He was beaten in the ball hitting. Again, it was poorly thrown.
Washington maybe still learning the position a little bit. He was a converted tight end. Granger on 3rd and 10. Complete to Carter, and this time he catches it. And he's down to the 17-yard line. So Granger, unlucky once and twice, but the third time he hits him for a 22-yard pickup, tackled by Carlton Buckles.
Boy, he's a load, isn't he? 216 pounds, almost looks like his brother. Everybody remembers Michael Carter for the 49ers. Look at him keep his balance. He's got that low center of gravity, pulls himself back up, and has a gain, big gain. Carter now, 4 for 42 yards.
And a first down, Greg, pardon me, that's his running mate, his homeboy Rodney Thomas, tackled in the backfield by Crowell. William Crowell making the tackle that time.
Tackled by William Crowell.
Well, Rodney Thomas is the backup tailback, but he pushes Greg Hill very hard every day in practice.
To be successful against Texas A&M, you've got to get them in second and long, third and long situations. That's why Bill Walsh and Stanford were successful defensively against him. Now here you've got second down and 11. They've got to stop him here again to bring up third and long.
Come out with two wide receivers to the top of the screen.
He's checking off.
A blitz. Looking for the hot receiver. Incomplete. They got good pressure on him, and Granger is down on the turf. He got rocked.
How about Aubrey Hillary? Another chance for an interception. I think that ball hit him in the chest plate. Watch this. The two safeties are splitting the hash. They've cocked on the hash. They're in the middle. Now the play comes over the middle. Here's Granger. First, he gets hit from behind and goes down hard. But then the two safeties converge on the ball, and they almost had an interception.
Blown opportunities by the LSU defense. Third down and 11. Handoff to Carter. They run it, and they'll be short of the first down. Be about 4 yards short.
Carter carry.
Good, solid defensive effort by LSU. Had their backs against the wall, really backed up into the red zone, the four down area, and they made three really nice defensive plays.
Ray Adams and James Gilliard came in to make the tackle. And now here's Terry Vinatulius, 13 of 18 last year. The longest of 44. This guy has an accurate leg.
Yeah, he led the West Conference in scoring. 72% field goal percentage.
This one from 30 yards out, and a flag, and this might be a first down if it's against LSU.
Golly. If you're Curly Holman, you've got to be tearing your hair out. A young football team, first game, and they're killing themselves. It's not A&M, it's LSU beating themselves right now. Well, there's the sixth penalty.
We talked about Curly tearing his hair out. He looks like a candidate for Hair Club for Men. All those penalties so far. And it'll be first and goal for the Aggies. Jeff Granger, a brand new man this weekend.
Granger's got to get him in and out of the huddle. He came out late. It's already down to 10. Play clock.
Carter and Hill in the backfield. This is Hill. It's Greg Hill time down to the 2.5 yard line. They've got the three. Greg Hill with some big statements earlier in the week.
Yeah, he said that he could run for 150 to 200 yards against anybody. Right now, 7 carries, 39 yards. He's the Mad Hatter.
He said he'd run for 150 or 200, like you said, and that Thomas, in addition to that, would run for between 100 and 150. Going with their two tight ends here. The toss to Hill. Good surge by the LSU defense, nothing doing.
Strong safety, Rodney Young came up. He read it in his safety position and actually made that hit. Great play by Young. I'll tell you this about Hill. With all of his success last year, he's lost the element of surprise. Every time he's in that backfield, the defense is keying on him.
Tough to surprise everybody twice.
Oh, what a play by the safety. He's a big kid, too. 6'2", 208 pounds, Young is.
And he beat Daryl McCorvey out for the starting job at strong safety. Third and goal. Quick drop, Granger. Incomplete, and a nice hit that time. The pass intended for Percy Singleton.
But again, it was Young. Here's a guy who made two big plays in a row. Came up, made the tackle, and then gets the big hit here.
Rodney getting much respect.
I'll tell you this, if I'm playing on that LSU defense, I'm going over and I'm going to congratulate this guy. Look at Young come up, tuck the tail, and drive right through the receiver. Outstanding play.
Vinatulius in for a 23-yard field goal. LSU catches a big break.
The penalty actually helped LSU. They got closer to the goal line because of the uprights that had been pulled in. He had a more severe angle, and he missed it.
And the hash marks remain wide. They moved the uprights in last year, but the hash marks haven't moved. Boy, is that a huge break or what?
Hitachi. They make... Oh, a great shot. Now, what was I saying?
Hitachi makes camcorders and 20,000 other products worth celebrating. Hitachi.
Hitachi. Oh, wait, I should know what they make. I mean, I try.
shop all the time.
Hitachi makes escalators and 20,000 other sophisticated products. Hitachi.
Getting to know you.
I drove literally every car in the same class. It boiled down to, I wanted a Geostorm.
Guys like a girl that knows how to drive a stick.
There's 140 horses in here. Can you...
Hello? Horses. The cockpit's laid out like a jet.
You don't have to be a race car driver to drive a Storm, but you sure feel like one.
If this car had wings, it would fly.
Now's the time to get to know Geo Storm, right around the corner at your Chevrolet Geo dealers.
When your home is damaged, State Farm is there, fast. You see, when you have a homeowner's insurance claim with State Farm, you report it to your agent, and right away we team up with State Farm claims people.
We work with your agent to avoid needless hassles and delays so you can get your home back together as soon as possible.
Our teamwork speeds your claim. It's another reason why State Farm is such an outstanding homeowner's insurance value. State Farm is there!
7-0 A&M. It could have been worse than Tullius, who had hit six in a row dating back to last year, had a severe angle here, and watch what he does. Just leaves it out to the right. Tried to overcompensate the angle and left it out there, like a golfer blocking a shot out to the right.
Luke hands it off to Robert Davis out to the 20-yard line. Barely got back to the line of scrimmage.
Robert Davis carried.
You'd think that LSU would try and get some momentum
tackle
for that missed field goal.
We're trying.
And there is one of the richest men in all of professional sports, the Shaq. First round draft choice of the Orlando Magic.
Look at him. You're clean, Shaq. You're clean.
Yeah, with his bread, I'd be clean too. Luke passing on second down. They're blitzing and they get him. Jason Atkinson lowering the boom. They came with a dog that time and got him.
Second sack of the game. A loss of 10. We told you they had 56 sacks last year. Here they outnumber people. Look at this. Luke, wonder if he just didn't have anybody open because he certainly cocked. Looked like he was going to throw. We may say that's a coverage sack or else he saw the blitz coming and just pulled it down. But that's the second sack today. This club will come after you. They are aggressive.
Yeah, they look a lot better than last week. Third down and 20 to go. Luke to the near sideline. And the pass is ruled complete to Scott Ray.
Remember, you only need 1 foot in college football. This gets him back to the original line of scrimmage. Now they're going to say, no, he didn't catch it.
They're going to take it away.
Here's a look. Watch his feet. He's dragging him here. That's a catch.
Yeah, he had that.
What they're going to say is the back judge is going to say when he rolled his ankle was on that line.
So the Tigers will have to punt it. 8:48 remaining in the first half of play. And it's 7-0 for Texas A&M. Brian DeSales in to punt.
Why that's a big call is not because it would have gotten them first down. It would have only gotten them back to the line of scrimmage, the original line of scrimmage. But it would have given them yardage, more room to punt.
Kirk Fraser standing on his 40-yard line. Under heavy pressure, he gets off a nice punt. Fair catch called at the 47. A 43-yard punt and nothing on the return. We'll be back in the house after this short break.
For new vehicle quality, Chevrolet is the best full-size pickup. That's a quote from J.D. Power and Associates, one of the most authoritative research companies in the automotive business. Chevrolet is the best full-size pickup, the highest initial quality in its class. Only Chevrolet, the trucks you can depend on, the trucks that last.
I've been a college president and a college football coach. I've seen how football teaches leadership, discipline, and team spirit. Promise of Tomorrow encourages the talented young people in college football to bring these qualities into the classroom by becoming teachers.
Hitachi is proud to sponsor the College Football Association. Hitachi's Promise of Tomorrow program gives teaching scholarships to all 67 CFA members.
If all college students were alike, a university could be a dull place. There'd be no new ideas, no different points of view, and nothing unique to share. Louisiana State University is proud of the outstanding diversity of our students. Every day, we learn more about people and the world around us. At LSU, education is more than what you learn in class. It's what you learn in life.
We told you earlier about Greg Hill's statement saying how he was going to run left, right, and center all over the LSU defense. Well, you think that LSU got a copy of it? This is inside the LSU locker room.
This is his statement. I'm going to run for 150, 200 yards. We can run on anybody in the country. We can play smash mouth on anybody. They are doing that. Now, last week, Stanford held him. 13 carries, 32 yards, so he struggled. But here today, he's got 8 carries, 36 yards, starting to break out of it a little bit.
It's like my dad used to say, never let your mouth write a check that your body can't cash.
He can cash it.
He is so far today. Matthews in motion. Rodney Thomas tripped up and falls down at the 45. Back to New York, and John Saunders.
USC and San Diego State. Watch a nice fake by Rob Johnson. And across the middle, he threads the needle to Johnny Morton. 24 yards and a touchdown. It's 14-7. Mark.
All right, USC in tough this year in the Pac-10. Larry Smith with a disappointing season last year, but looking good so far. Second down and 12 for A&M down on the field here. Action out of the eye. You know, Jeff Granger can run a little bit. Last week, he had a 33-yard run that set up the game-winning field goal, and there you see a bit of his elusiveness. He's not particularly fast or speedy, but he is elusive.
Well, here he shows speed. The blitz comes. He sees the blitz, reads it, sets up on the wagon. Now look, he gets outside. There's contain right there, but Swan, 35, can't keep him in. And so then it has to be the backside pressure from Washington, who's a tight end. He's got pretty good speed.
Hey, pitchers aren't supposed to run that well, are they?
Yeah, he can get it. I'll tell you this, though. He's only hit two of his last nine. So that run won't get it.
Two tight ends and Schwab and McKeon. This is Hill out of the backfield. And Greg Hill is down to the 40-yard line into LSU territory. A pickup of 11 yards.
And it's got the first down. Again, missed tackles.
Rodney Thomas coming in now for Hill. He'll take a breather. This Monday night, it doesn't get any better than this. The Washington Redskins taking on the Dallas Cowboys in Dallas. And Michael Irvin, Tim, is signed now. They got all the guys back, except their center, of course. But this should be a great game.
Well, it's an interesting game. Michael Irvin just came in. Stepnoski's still holding out, but they do have Charles Haley. Casillas is hurt, and so is Russell Maryland. That'll hurt the Cowboys.
Right here, this is Rodney Thomas. Leaps high down to the 36. Now, Thomas was at the center of a recruiting war, actually, between LSU and Texas A&M. People at LSU knew that Greg Hill was going to be at A&M, and they were telling him, well, you don't need to go there and back him up.
And others on the tackle.
But Thomas ended up going there anyway. And a recruiting war, an intense one, that went right down to the final moments. Second down and six. Ranger lets go of it. Incomplete for the tight end, Greg Short. Short played out for it, but couldn't get there.
He was open, too. A&M has to go to the tight ends more. He had four receptions last week. He was open all night. Talented receiver. For some reason, Ranger just can't hit him.
Granger has cooled off quite a bit since that opening drive.
This is the first penalty against A&M this afternoon.
With 6:26 remaining in the second quarter. Look at discipline.
Texas A&M penalized 10 yards. Holding. Still second down.
Now defensively, you want to be smart here. I mean, it's second down and a taxi ride for A&M. Granger's hit three of his last 10, so you know he's not really hot right now. Reveille 5, the dog right there, shaking things up.
It's got to be hot down there, too, over close to 100 degrees anyway.
Granger's not hot. in the eye. Matthews to the near side of the field. Granger looking for him, and he throws incomplete. He was hit from behind as he released the ball by Clayton Mouton. He was looking for Matthews.
Had plenty of time, too. It wasn't a blitz, but Mouton, 59, look at him on the left of your screen, coming up, or the right of your screen, rather, comes up from behind. Curly Holman told him, he says, hey, listen, Clayton, we expect more out of you this year. You've got to make some big plays. He was hurt a lot last year, but he makes a big one there.
One of the few starting seniors on that defensive unit. Third and New Orleans to go. Granger out of the shotgun this time. All day to pass it. Almost intercepted. Vincent Fuller, the free safety, came over and batted it down and almost had an interception.
This is a surprise. A&M was supposed to dominate. They aren't. As a matter of fact, LSU has had time and time again chances to turn this game around. They get out of the first half 7-0. It's a great thing for LSU. Look at this. He's got all day, throws a poor pass, and then Miller tags him anyway.
Tim, if you're LSU, though, it's got to bother you that Granger does have a lot of time to throw. And they talked about blitzing a little bit. I'm not sure if they're doing it, but they haven't gotten there. David Davis with a nice punt down to the 8-yard line. Buckles. And he's dropped at the 10. 45-yard. 7 yards on the return. Well, coming up at halftime on the Prudential Halftime Report, John and Bo. Sounds like a good TV show. Run down the top 25 scores and bring you the latest college football news and highlights. A story coming up on the Miami Hurricanes and Hurricane Andrew, the effect that it had on that team. Ryan Huffman in the ballgame now at quarterback. On the toss, the option to Robert Davis. And Davis has got some room. Has he got the juice? A 76-yard bolt of lightning called Robert Davis, deep into Texas A&M territory.
Huffman makes this play, gets rid of it quickly, he sees the blitz. Now watch the freshman. Here comes Davis. Gets the block, turns it up, now cuts back against the pursuit. Oh, but Aaron Glenn, this is a foot race. Watch the top of your screen. Glenn turns on the jets. He's behind 5 yards and still makes it up on Davis, who runs out of steam. Still a great play for LSU. Here come the Bengal Tigers.
Tim, the big play that they were looking for.
Prior to that, LSU had lost 12 yards in two possessions. They needed a big play.
And Curley sends in Ryan Huffman at quarterback. Curley switching things up.
Yeah, but as nice as that was of Huffman to make the play and get rid of it quickly, that was all Davis.
Yeah, getting rid of it was called good career planning. He saw the defender coming in a hurry.
Picked his way, waited for his blockers, looked like he was tap dancing on a leg ball. All of a sudden saw the pursuit and got through it. Bingo, 76 yards.
Mr. Football in the state of Alabama last year.
I'll tell you what I'd do. I'd come back right now on first down and go for the end zone.
Let's see what kind of package they come with at the 8-yard line.
If nothing else, it'll get the number one defense in the nation thinking. Loosen them up a little bit.
They've got two tight ends in.
He's open.
Huffman rolling out. He's going to take it himself. And he's in. Ryan Huffman is getting this team with the program.
He had a receiver open. He also had the run open. Watch this now. Frazier commits to the receiver, 23. When he goes in, there's no containment. Once you get outside, Huffman has the corner. All he's got to do now is punch it in. He's not big, 6'2", 210 pounds, but he punches it.
And Pedro Suarez sneaks it inside the upright. Hey, they strike quickly. Two plays, 84 yards. They only use 23 seconds, but it's a tie ball game.
You think his heart isn't pumping? His adrenaline's not flowing? He comes in and two plays. The redshirt freshman takes him to distance.
Boy, Curly Hallman goes to the bullpen and finds some big-time relief.
Now, if you are C. Slocum at Texas A&M, this is the last thing you want, is to get the crowd in it and to get these young kids from LSU confidence, believing they can do it. You have to wonder what happened to the outside containment for Texas A&M. There was nobody out there to force it back in. Neely got caught inside.
Tim, do you think that's because the linebackers for A&M pursued so well they got frozen that time or held?
Well, it's a possibility, obviously. But anytime Neely's playing on the outside, 56, and you can see him in that replay, he gets caught in, sucked in. By that time, now you're chasing rather than forcing back in where your help's coming from.
Any way you spell it, it's sevens are wild up on the scoreboard.
I'll tell you this, too. Odell Beckman, the fullback, he threw a great block to free that corner.
Ryan Huffman, number three on the depth chart, a quarterback, comes in and puts 7 points on the board. Matt Herkamp to kick it off. Ray Mickens and Billy Mitchell. Number 10. This is Mitchell. Leans out over the 30-yard line, out to the 31. Coming up later tonight on ABC, number one ranked Miami Hurricanes taking on Iowa. Big story there, of course, Lamar Thomas cleared to play in that ballgame.
Well, that's right. He's able to play tonight. Their leading receiver, he was charged in financial aid scandal, but a legal agreement has paved the way to play. Ironically, he did not sue or take the legal case against the NCAA. Did it instead against the university, so legally they've got to let him play.
Looks like now they may settle out of court. This is Rodney Thomas running hard over the 35 to the 37. Good looking run that time by Rodney Thomas. Tim, you'd think it'd be important here for the LSU defense to come up with a big defensive stand to keep some of that momentum.
Sure, and the heat is a factor. I mean, it's over 90 degrees. We were down on the field. It's very hot. But I don't know if you've noticed what Curly Hallman is doing. He's rotating his defensive personnel. His front line comes in for two series, and then he comes and brings the backups in for a couple of plays and another series, so everybody should stay fairly fresh.
The wheel's turning with Mike Hogarth. Rodney Thomas. And he'll have the first down up to the 45. And more troops coming in for LSU for the sidelines. Look at the difference in rushing yards, but most of that, of course, coming on that run by Robert Davis.
76-yard run by Davis. But, you know, you have to really sit back and admire R.C. Slocum's club, Texas A&M. They don't look rattled. They're staying in this ball game. He wants to win a national title. Unfortunately, see a player down. Unfortunately, a lot of people don't take anybody out of the Southwest Conference very seriously right now because they've lost three straight Cotton Bowls.
And last year, they lost 10-2. Against Florida State in a very tough defensive game.
We'll be playing Kent State tonight. After this,
we're going to take a break, but we'll be right back. Stick around.
Across the street in the Pete Maravich Assembly Center.
Rivals collide as the Washington Redskins tackle the Dallas Cowboys. Last year, Washington captured the Super Bowl title. Now the Redskins are the team to beat, and Dallas feels they're the team to do just that. It's a blockbuster battle on the season premiere of ABC's Monday Night Football.
Sunday, American Detective puts on a summer sting.
Hey, can you come over here?
Yeah, if it's not a setup here.
On a special one-hour American Detective Sunday.
Well, the injured player on that last play was John Elliser, one of the, well, actually the best offensive lineman on that Texas A&M squad up front.
Watch 51, could be the best offensive lineman at right guard in the Southwest Conference. Former nose guard, plays tough, All-American candidate. He gets tied up in here, they roll up on him, and he goes out. The good news is he walked out, so hopefully it's not a serious injury. There's a guy that'll be in the NFL, 6'3", 280 pounds, and moves well.
They churned them out at Texas A&M. First down and 10. Granger play action. A little waggle play. He's got a man open. He hits Beggins. Beggins cuts back and is down to the 19-yard line. That pass was almost picked off, but Wilbert Beggins picked up 34 yards the other way.
Now that was a well-thrown ball, but the reason it went big is because Ray Adams gambled. He had him 1-on-1, the cornerback came up, tried to make the pick, went for the interception. Now watch him gamble now. Here's the play action. That stops everybody up. Now the waggle brings it out by himself, drills this ball, but I want you to watch 21 in purple. He goes for the interception right here. There's nobody else there. Biggins takes it down now for the big gainer.
Granger threw a dart that time, comes back gunning again. All day to throw, wide open over the middle. Down to the 3-yard line. Ray Adams making the tackle, and that was Beggins one more time. Wilbert Beggins. Two times, twice as nice as the ball lays on the 4-yard line now.
Should I say it again? The composure of A&M. You have to be impressed with it. They give up the big play. They give up the touchdown. They come back offensively, and they drive it right down LSU's throat.
Gross and Thomas in the backfield. A short in motion. This is Rodney Thomas. Cuts it back. And he's stopped up by Ivory Hillier. The backup free safety with some surge. Put a 6-foot, 186-pound body right in there.
And Bukov on the start.
Look at the fire out. Look at the blocking. Half the guys are on the line. The play's made by Deschatel. Once he stood up, that's when Ivory comes in. But it was Deschatel that really made that thing work. Stopped the touchdown. They go to number 46.
Second down and goal. Handoff this time again, and it is right on the 1-yard line. Actually, the foot, 1 foot away from the end zone. Corey White making the stop on Thomas.
Ricardo Washington again. He's in here. Corey White's in here. Bang, right there. 54. White stops the touchdown.
Inches from the end zone. And a timeout on the field. By R.C. Slocum. So they remaining. 2:28 to play in the first half. They'll be staring at third and goal when they come back.
Talking about the goal line defense here, you want to get everybody down as low as they can. You want the defensive linemen to slice in between the offensive linemen and dive into the backfield. You want them a yard deep. Establish a new line of scrimmage, and then the linebackers have to fill very quickly. So you want to get a pile up, let the linebackers fill the secondary guys. What you have to be careful of here is a quick rollout or a little high percentage passing in the end zone, a little dump off
the tight end.
Yeah, but again, it's the outside guys. You know, they're flood control. They can't let that happen. If you're going and you're a running team like A&M for the most part, you just have to get in that goal line defense, hit those first line guys, Miller, Cole, and Mouton, to really slice in there, cause havoc, have the linebackers fill, and try to stop them before they cross that imaginary plane.
Well, they'll probably be coming back with their jumbo package here. Two tight ends, Greg Short and James McKeon.
This is important since that opening touchdown. They've had 3 punts and a missed field goal.
The ball is just inside the one. Let's listen. No signal, and now they get it. Touchdown, Jeff Granger. Jeff Granger keeps it himself. Gutsy call, Tim.
It's not so much a gutsy call, but the composure of that man and his ball club. I mean, they mixed up first down plays. They threw more high percentage passes. They got it down into 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 5. Granger looked more confident, and he gets the touchdown.
I think he's just said the key word. He seems so much more sure of himself this week. Vinatulius with the extra point.
Vinatulius' kick is good.
And the Aggies have taken a 14-7 lead. Unlike last year when they led 7-0 after the first quarter, they scored 28 points take a 35-0 lead at halftime.
Defensive line did its job here. Look, they got it. Linebackers and secondary just guessed incorrectly. You've got to get up there and meet him right now. You cannot let him surge. He only needs a yard.
What do you think? Is that inexperience on the part of the LSU defense? The youth, maybe?
Well, that might be part of it, but that was not bad. That was not bad defense. You just, once you're down there on the run, it's a guessing game anyway.
Well, A&M takes it 7 plays, 69 yards, using 3:13 on the dial. They lead 14-7. So they answer that touchdown by LSU and take back the momentum.
Well, in that drive, too, they had 2 passes, 5 runs, mixed their plays better, used some play action.
It is hot down on the field. .26 remaining. Nothing but blue skies in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Season opener for both these teams. Next week, Texas A&M takes on Tulsa, the only team that they lost to last year, other than Florida State.
That game's in College Station this year, though. It's payback time.
And Atulius with the kickoff. David Butler's going to run it out. The freshman's got an alley. And the kicker brings him down at the 42-yard line. Terry Venetulius made the touchdown-saving tackle, but a return by the freshman of 60 yards.
How about this? I think what makes this go is his hesitation here. He catches it, hesitates, looks. Now a lot of the guys in their lanes have already overrun the play. Look, they're flying by him. Once he breaks that first wave, the only trouble is he's pinned into the sidelines, and the kicker does a nice job. Venetulius does a nice job of using that sideline like an extra player.
Ryan Huffman still at the reins. Completes the pass to Scott Ray, and Ray is down to the 24-yard line. A pickup of 17, LSU back on the move.
How about Huffman? 3 plays, every one has been positive. A 76-yarder, a touchdown, and now that one for 17.
Now you really can't underestimate the factor of a quarterback being able to watch something on the side and see what's going wrong.
Well, and you see this early success he's having here, you can tell he feels he can't do anything wrong now. I mean, he actually almost threw that sidearm while he was running left to get it out to make the completion to Ray.
And there's a timeout on the field taken by LSU. They now have 2 remaining.
Boy, don't give him too much time to think. Right now, it's an automatic pilot.
I'm thinking about Butler, and he looked like he was going to take the touchback for a minute, but I guess that's a great thing about freshmen. Sometimes they just don't know any better.
I will guarantee you, if you go back and take a highlight film of the big returns, almost all of them come after maybe a bobble or a hesitation or a slip step. Because then, people who are supposed to stay in their lanes in coverage then overrun it. They leave their lanes because they think it's either dead or they're down to the point where they've already gone beyond the cover point. They leave their lanes. If he comes out, he breaks one man, bingo.
A year ago today, in this very same game, the score was 7-7. Actually, it was 7-0 after the first quarter of play, and it was 35-0. At halftime for Texas A&M over LSU.
See if Huffman can keep this going. First play, 76 yards. Second play, touchdown at 17-yard pass.
Leslie Jacob in motion. Handoff is to James Jacquette. And Jacquette makes it down to the 22-yard line. Pick up about 3 on the play. Larry Jackson, the right inside linebacker, making the tackle.
Jackson made the tackle.
Jackson, 6'4", 242 pounds, a sophomore. We'd like to allow 5 seconds for our ABC stations to identify themselves.
Channel 13, Houston KTRK-TV.
Huffman on the option play, kept it himself and got dropped at the 23, maybe a loss of 1 yard.
So you're caught. Your 5-second pause was just enough for the defense to regroup.
And they identified themselves.
Cycleman's playing a heck of a game, you know that?
Cycleman.
He's been solid so far. He was last year as well, started 11 games.
You want to hear an astounding statistic? Give it to me. Since 1985, Texas A&M has had 316 sacks.
Boy. Still getting over it. Number one, Miami, taking on Iowa. 0-1 so far this season. They lost to NC State earlier last week. That game coming up, 8 o'clock Eastern, 7 o'clock Central, 5 o'clock Pacific. So many people picking Miami to win the national championship. Iowa trying to rebound from that, a better football team than they showed in the kickoff classic. And it's going to be interesting to see how the players respond for Miami after the tragedy they've had. Dennis Erickson lost his home. A couple of the players lost theirs. Barrow's mother lost her home. Michael Barrow, one of their star linebackers. So they're playing with a great deal of pressure and burden on their shoulders.
And a heavy heart.
Third and 8. 1:10 remaining in the first half. Ryan Huffman has come in and sparked this LSU offense. Flags down. May have been offside against A&M. Huffman incomplete. Don't know who he was trying to hit that time. Maybe Harold Bishop, the tight end, who came back to help him out.
Smart play. Threw it to Bishop to alleviate the yardage loss in the sack. However, there's a penalty anyway because Texas A&M jumped. And I'll tell you what, if you go back and you look at that line of scrimmage, I think it was Huffman who actually thought the ball was coming on an earlier count. When he moved, A&M came across, but it was A&M which got tagged with a penalty. He was the guy in motion, I think.
Jermaine Williams now checking into the backfield for the Tigers. Curley Hallman shuttling those backs in and out. Jake Johnson coming out. The backs line up in the eye. On third and 3. Ray and Jacob split wide. Backside pressure coming. He gets it off and it's incomplete. Who's trying to find Odell Beckham. But he got dropped by Steve Solari and Marcus Buckley at the pressure.
Oh, what a heady play, though, by a redshirt freshman. Now, he can't see the pressure coming from behind. What he does see is he sees the pressure coming in front of him from Solari. That causes him to turn around and go the other way, sees the blitz there, and then rather than take the loss, the second time in a row, he throws it and alleviates the loss and sets up the field goal.
In comes Hurkamp. Matt Hurkamp, 35 yards out, not Pedro Suarez. That may be a bit of a surprise. And he misses this one. He hooks it to the left. Matt Hurkamp misfires from 35 yards out.
Tough snap to handle. As a matter of fact, Daigle, who's the quarterback, is the holder, actually bobbled the ball before he got it up, threw the timing off a little bit. Take another look now. Daigle is the guy on the knee. He is the holder. Now the snap comes back and Daigle mishandles it. Watch this. See number two? Watch this. Boom. Pecked it up. By then the timing's off. You can't really give Hurkamp all the blame on that.
Yeah, that replay gets the kicker off the hook.
Nonetheless, LSU hurts themselves again when they had an opportunity.
55 seconds remaining and a flag down on the field.
This will be holding against the Aggies. Back them up a little bit.
Carter Washington making the tackle that time on Greg Thrill Hill.
Hill carry.
If you're LSU, though, you're pretty happy with the first half.
Yet. There's 48 Washington. Seconds left. They're going to move it back here on the penalty for holding. LSU's going to have tremendous field position if they can stop them here. They've got to utilize the clock.
Greg Hill still says that he's going to run for 150 or 200 yards. And you saw statistics, he's at 38 right now.
Right? Now the clock stops at 38 seconds. LSU has one timeout left. They've got to utilize that. They've got to hope for something here. They don't have a lot of time. Clock starts again now that the ball's reset.
Granger will walk up and face first and 20. Hand off is to Carter. Carter pulling his way out to the 19. Make that quick gross.
You just gonna let that play, the clock go. Get out of here, just trailing 14-7.
Corey White made the tackle that time.
That's the end of the first half. The score 14-7, Texas A&M. We'll be back after these messages.
CFA College Football, this ABC Sports exclusive, brought to you by Chevy Trucks, the trucks you can depend on, the trucks that last. And by the Beef Industry Council and Beef Board. Beef, it's what's for dinner.
Kinder? Gentler? No way.
I go around. I was strong as I could be. I go around. Nothing ever got to me.
Chevy S10 pickup, powered by the biggest V6 available, Chevy trucks. The trucks you can depend on, the trucks that last. Now it's easy to own a Chevy truck.
Nothing satisfies so many people in so many different ways. Beef, it's what's for dinner.
Each year, corporate America spends over $10 billion on overnight shipping. Yet according to a report in the Wall Street Journal, $3 billion of that is wasted. If you find that kind of inefficiency alarming, call UPS. We can save you up to 40% on overnight deliveries and help prevent your profits from going up in smoke. UPS. We run the tightest ship in the shipping business.
All right, ladies, we're roommates now, and you're pumped?
Hey, we're pumped.
Spirit is the key. Are you pumped?
We're pumped.
We share the rent?
We're pumped.
Are you pumped?
We're pumped.
We share the housework?
Ooh, we're pumped.
We share me? Pumped? Are you pumped?
Pumped. You're dreaming.
Mark Curry, Holly Robinson, and Don Lewis in Hangin' with Mr. Cooper, premiering Tuesday, September 22nd.
I was this close.
Today's engines are precise works of art that need protection for all the ways you... That's why you should insist on Exxon Superflow Motor Oil. It coats metal parts to reduce startup friction, prevents harmful sludge buildup from short trips, and protects from the heat of highway driving. For advanced engine protection, rely on the Tiger. Exxon Superflow. For all the ways you drive.
I went to Builder's Square for a mailbox. Nice, huh? You know how it is. The low prices at Builder Square just make you want to build, build, build!
And save, especially on a Black & Decker cordless screwdriver. It has a wall-mount charger, it's reversible, and it's just $13.
Check this out. These look tweaky. Builder Square, the warehouse with everything for your house this Labor Day.
Channel 13 cares about Texas.
From ABC Sports, this is the Prudential Halftime Report. In a changing world, one thing remains rock solid, the Prudential. Now from New York, John Saunders.
Welcome back once again to New York and the Prudential Halftime Report. Let's look at some scores and highlights, but start with a reminder at 8 o'clock Eastern Time here on ABC, number 1 Miami facing number 23 Iowa. In that game, Lamar Thomas, the wide receiver who was under investigation for financial aid fraud, will be eligible to play thanks to a deal he's worked out with the U.S. attorney, but he hasn't practiced since August the 18th. Let's continue with the scores and highlights. The Fighting Irish in Notre Dame, boy, they've got their hands full against Northwestern at Soldier Field in Chicago. Lee Gissendaner, you want to watch a pretty play. The fake here, and they give it to Gissendaner on the reverse, 14 yards, ties the game 7-7. Lee Becton, though, a 2-yard run, took it in to put Notre Dame up 4. 14-7 in the game. Northwestern, though, has had the ball 18 minutes, 10 seconds, or about 60% of the time. Texas A&M and LSU, you're watching this game. It's gone to the half, 14-7. Jeff Granger with a one-yard touchdown run to put A&M into the lead. Vanderbilt at number 9, Alabama. Bama rolls 25-8, celebrating 100 years of Crimson Tide football. The Commodores must have wanted to help them celebrate because they kept fumbling the ball and turning it over with interceptions here. 6 turnovers, 5 in the first half. Watch this botch punt here. Sets up a second quarter Alabama touchdown as well. And then late in the game, Marcus Wilson picked off by Michael Rogers. 31 yards for the touchdown. Pays the price at the end. Alabama 25-8 is a winner in this contest. 6 turnovers for Vanderbilt. Nebraska over Utah, 49-22. Mike Grant with 2 rushing touchdowns. He's the quarterback for the Huskers. Colorado and Bill McCartney with a new look in the backfield. Just one back set, 37-17. It's working. Cordell Stewart, though, with 3 touchdown passes in the game. Clemson, a win over Ball State. This one closer than it looked, 24-10, but it was 10-10 late. Touchdown run for Clemson put them ahead for good. Another great one involved number 17 Ohio State facing Louisville. This one a one-point contest. Everybody waiting for Robert Smith to come back after missing the entire year of football, but it was number 7 Joey Galloway here who has the nifty moves and finds his way to the end zone for the touchdown. 50 yards in the play, 10-0. Ohio State would take the lead. Smith, meanwhile, had to leave the game with a rib injury in the third quarter, did not return. Louisville, though, pulled it within 1. It was 20-19, and Jeff Braum with a chance here, but the pass falls away on the 2-point conversion. As a result, Ohio State hangs on for the second year in a row. It comes down to the final play of the game. 20-19 is that final. Number 19, California, all over San Jose State at halftime. 31-8 is that score. Doug Barr to Sean Dawkins for 2 touchdowns in that contest. Other top 25 games that come later tonight, including number 1 Miami against number 23 Iowa. You can see that one. NC State has a big contest against Appalachian State as they look to go 2-0. And some idle teams from the top 25. Michigan facing the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. So Notre Dame has to have that win against Northwestern. It's a tough one next week. In the Big East, they started their season today. Rutgers and Boston College, 37-20, the final here. Keith Miller, 2 touchdown receptions for the Eagles, and Darnell Campbell, 2 rushing scores and 100 yards plus. In the ACC, Wake Forest and Bill Dooley, a loser, 35-17 here. Michael Falkerson ran 3 scores, and Natroni Means carried 21 times for 112 yards for Carolina. Southern Miss against Memphis State, 23-21 the final here. Freshman kicker Johnny Lamoro nailed a 52-yard field goal in his first college kick with 10 seconds left to give Southern Miss the win. Ohio U and Iowa State, 21-9 in the third quarter there. The Citadel, they are 4-1 lifetime against 1A football teams. They are 1AA, and right now they have the lead over Arkansas out of the SEC, 10-3 is that score. Justin Bomer, 34-yard touchdown, fumble recovery, the difference in the game. USC and San Diego State, this one's been a passing display by Rob Johnson. As you look at Marshall Faulk, who had a pretty good first half, 54 yards. Johnson goes to Johnny Morton here, 24 yards. Rob Johnson has passed for 3 touchdowns in the game, 2 of those to Johnny Morton. And at halftime, USC has the lead, 21-7. We'll also follow baseball in the pennant races. The Toronto Blue Jays, they've let the Baltimore Orioles come right back to them. But for the second day in a row, they blow up the Minnesota Twins. 7-3 is the final. The Jays right now with a 1-game lead pending the outcome of the Baltimore Orioles, who play the California Angels later tonight. And Boston and Oakland. Oakland let it get back to a game lead. They were up 7.5 when they traded Jose Canseco. 2-1, they lead Boston in the fifth inning. Back with more Prudential Halftime Report. But first, a look at some more scores from around the nation.
Changes, there is one certainty. The financial strength of the Prudential, rock solid in securities, insurance, and real estate.
At Texas A&M University, we're proud of our traditions, the old and the new. At Texas A&M, excellence is our greatest tradition.
In a world of constant change, there is one certainty: the financial strength of the Prudential, rock solid in securities, insurance, and real estate.
Welcome back to New York. I'm John Saunders. A reminder, later tonight, the number one team in the nation, the Miami Hurricanes, will face the Iowa Hawkeyes at 8 o'clock Eastern Time on ABC's College Football. Iowa needs the win because they already have a loss to NC State. Miami needs the victory to help erase the memories of Hurricane Andrew. In fact, they're still cleaning up in South Florida and Louisiana. Our Marianne Grabovoy has the story.
Time and time again, the language of war and destruction is used in the world of sports, especially football. Hit 'em, kill 'em, destroy 'em. But now, like never before, those words have new meaning for the players and coaches of the Miami Hurricanes. Even their nickname gives them pause.
Winning and losing is not near as important as life and death and the things that we went through. It's put life very much in perspective for myself and for this whole football team.
It, of course, is Hurricane Andrew. 3 days after ravaging South Florida, the team was sent 150 miles north of Miami to live and practice at the winter home of the LA Dodgers. It was a tough decision for Dennis Erickson, whose own home was severely damaged, whose wife and son are now living in his office.
I know that when we play Iowa Saturday, win, lose, or draw, I know this football team's going to leave everything that they have on the field, and it's going to be dedicated to all the people in South Florida.
You've learned something about life, huh?
Yeah, it's very short and very precious.
Several assistant coaches also lost their homes, and four of the Miami players, including middle linebacker Michael Barrow, are from Homestead, one of the hardest-hit areas in South Florida.
Coming out of Homestead High School, Michael Barrow was not only student council vice president, but an All-American linebacker and one of the highest recruited athletes in the state of Florida. His school is still standing, but the grounds are now a staging area for the military's cleanup operations in the aftermath of Andrew.
Once the storm passed, Michael remembers frantically trying to get from Miami to Homestead to find his mother.
I went to the door, my mom saw me and she came out.
He was in shock. And when you saw him and he saw you,
we just hugged each other and cried.
He was just happy that you were alive and you were okay, huh?
After helping his mother salvage what little they could of the house he grew up in, Michael Barrow reluctantly left Homestead and rejoined his team, a little weary, but a little wiser.
It's not what you have, it's who you are. Faith and love and the will to go on. That's what's in the people's heart.
No doubt in the hearts of the Miami players will be thoughts of Michael's mom and so many others left homeless.
I want them to get that championship again. I want them to win every game. We came through this. In so many ways, we are winners because we are alive.
As Marianne pointed out, the great irony in all of this, the team called the Hurricanes will help lead the rally back from Hurricane Andrew. If you to help in that rally back as well. Here's the Red Cross disaster relief number, 1-800-842-2200. You can call that to help people in Louisiana and South Florida as well. Back with more college football in just a moment.
Changes. There is one certainty. The financial strength of the Prudential, rock solid in securities, insurance, and real estate.
Making the right moves in the game takes quick thinking. I know I can't think fast or move fast without a clear head. If you use drugs, make the right move, the smart move. Get help. Don't use drugs.
If you or someone you know needs help or information concerning drug abuse, call this toll-free number, 1-800-662-HELP. This message provided by the NCAA.
Welcome back. This season, ABC Sports offers an unprecedented way to watch college football. In addition to the games you'll be able to see on your local ABC affiliate, you'll also be able to see games live on pay-per-view. For example, if you were a Notre Dame alumnus living on the west coast of the United States and you wanted to see the Fighting Irish play Northwestern today, you could call a cable operator and find out if he could dial in that game for you on pay-per-view in addition to any other game that ABC Sports is carrying on that day. So it will be a great year of college football, and we're going to get you back to the game in just a moment right here on ABC's College Football.
From ABC Sports, this has been the Prudential Halftime Report. In a changing world, one thing remains rock solid, the Prudential.
Our score at halftime in the heart of Cajun country in Baton Rouge, Texas A&M leads LSU. The score, 14-7.
Both Visa and American Express Gold cards can get you to La Roche-Guyon, one of the prettiest towns in France. But should something go wrong here, only Visa Gold can get you out.
You had to come to France, right?
Don't start, Martin.
Because La Roche-Guyon's only towing service...
No, we're not getting a tow truck. I can get this out.
...doesn't take American Express. Drink Visa Gold, delivering what really matters.
Jamal's from...
Honey, that means I eat France.
Oh. It's everywhere you want to be.
Hey, use a spark plug that's tested to fire clean for 30,000 miles. Motorcraft. Motorcraft quality parts. From Ford.
Oil, the lifeblood of your engine. So the most vital organ is your oil filter. That's why you need Fram Extra Guard. You need glass fiber paper stops more dirt than any other filter. Fram Extra Guard, the best protection ever.
All right, a great man once said, winning, gentlemen, isn't everything, it's the only thing.
Look, a grasshopper!
I formation, 34 sweep on two, got it?
Just give the ball to Matt, tell me when for his day, got it?
It starts every September with teams like the Turkey Creek Hawks, the Bronx Eagles, and the Newport Richey Giants. On fields where dads aren't only coaches, and oak trees mark the end zones. And a good day isn't determined by if you win or lose, but where you go after the game. So McDonald's would like to salute the players, the coaches, the families, everyone who helped make this season a perfect season.
Can you go to McDonald's now, Coach?
After the game, Lenny. This is only halftime. Now go sit down.
CFA College Football, brought to you by Lexus Luxury Automobiles, the result of a relentless pursuit of perfection.
Mr. Cook is the lead owner of this
home. Welcome back to Baton Rouge, everyone. Mark Jones and Tim Brandt in the house. And Tim, the story so far, an improved Jeff Granger for Texas A&M.
Yeah, and five of his nine completions were to running backs, so they are high percentage passes. They built his confidence. He really hadn't had to overextend himself.
Now they took the lead 7-0 on this run by Granger. Nice pass.
There's Doug Carter, Michael Carter's brother, takes it in. He's got the first touchdown. It was 7-0. Stayed that way seemingly forever. But it was a young player who came in and really made the difference. Now, to get on track, Huffman came in at quarterback for LSU. Watch this. Here we go. Huffman fakes. Not a great play fake. Now kicks it back. And here he comes. Robert Davis, 76 yards, cut back against the grain. Glenn finally tracked him down, but after 76 yards, and it set up the LSU touchdown.
Longest run by a freshman since Harvey Williams.
And watch the young quarterback here. Again, it's play action, rolls out. Now Oldham is open in the end zone, but instead, Huffman pulls it down. Oldham comes back. Makes makes a key block. Huffman bangs it in for the score. Ryan Huffman, a redshirt freshman out of Houston, Texas, really coming in and sparking this team. That tied it at 7. A&M then got a touchdown quarterback sneak from Granger, and that's the way it is right now, 14-7. You know, you take that Davis 76-yard runaway, LSU has just 104 yards. The thing that's really hurt LSU, miscues, 6 penalties, a missed field goal, they were sacked twice, so they've really hurt themselves.
And also defensively, Tim, LSU missed plenty of opportunities on defense, interceptions. They could have had at least 3 of them so far.
Well, that's right. And if you're on the Mad Hatter watch, Greg Hill, he's got 8 carries, 36 yards. Granger, 9 for 18, 140 yards and a touchdown. Loop was the starting quarterback for LSU. He went 3 for 7, and Huffman came in 1 for 2 in the touchdown. Story so far, though, has been the young freshman, Davis. We talked about him at the top of the show. 6 carries, 93 yards.
LSU looking a lot better than they did last year in the same game. They trailed 35-0 at halftime.
And keep this in mind. LSU won the opening toss and deferred. They came on defensively. So now they will have the ball to start here in the second half. That's key.
Well, just a reminder of the American Red Cross relief number that we showed at halftime to aid those in Louisiana and Florida helping out with the relief from Hurricane Andrew. 1-800-842-2200.
There's a look at Ryan Huffman, 6'2", 210-pound freshman, although a redshirt freshman out of Houston, Texas. He came in and really put a spark to this LSU Bengal Tiger team.
He was ranked number 3 on the depth chart. Slowed down by a sore shoulder in spring training.
See the numbers of Granger at the top, and we told you most of those completions, 5 of them have been the running backs. Loop was not really that effective, but Huffman came in and certainly was.
Venetulius will kick it off for A&M. David Butler and Gary Pegues are back deep. This will be Butler. The big return earlier. Looking for another one. And he won't get it. He's tackled at the 24.
Butler returned the kickoff.
Tackle made on that play by Reggie Brown.
Interesting here that Curly Holman is coming back to Chad Luke, the junior, the more experienced quarterback, even though he was unable to really spark the offense. They talk about him in terms like strong character, very smart, makes good decisions.
Maybe trying to change up the pace again. Backs out of the offset eye. This is the rookie, Davis. Davis a gain of about 3 or 4 yards, tackled by Marcus Buckley.
England and Buckley.
Buckley coming off of that case of scarsoidosis, which is the inflammation of the joints. It affected him between the knee and the ankle, the left leg. They say he's only at about 80% right now. Beckham and Davis in the backfield. On 2nd and 6, Davis, big hole, jumps back, puts it on the ground, and Odell Beckham was there to get it for LSU.
Fumble was recovered by Odell.
Tackle was made by Eric England.
He is explosive. They didn't know what to expect out of him, but he got in, and he has really, really turned the juice on. He finds a hole. That just happens. I mean, that is excusable. England, Eric England, stripped him from behind, just slapped down at it. Good play, though, by Beckham to get it back.
1st and 10, Tigers. Davis again, getting some work. Runs into his own blocker, and he's stopped up at the 36-yard line, running over the left side that time. Pardon me, the right side.
Simnick almost got credit for the tackle, his right guard. Look at this guy, 290 pounds. Ronnie Simnick. He's out of Ocean Springs, Mississippi. He almost got credit for that tackle. Davis ran into him and just bounced off like a rubber ball.
Got to get those colors straight now. Davis and Beckham come out. And Jermaine Williams now is the lone back. 3 wide receivers with Jacob in the slot. Loop to pass.
Going to the far side, has a man, and it's picked off. And now it's stripped back.
That's a fumble, and that's LSU.
It's a Tiger football.
That was a completion, a fumble, and LSU gets it back.
Aaron Glenn had the ball and then had it taken away by Brett Besch.
Watch this now. It's a poorly thrown pass by Loop. I mean, he throws it up. They were ready to call a fair catch on this second. It was so high. All right, but then here comes Glenn. Comes inside out, gets it at its highest point. All right, now there it is, completion. One step, two step, three steps, and Besch takes it away. Ball's on the ground, gets it back. Recovers it between his legs. LSU ball.
Yeah, it's ruled an interception and a fumble.
That's the way it should be. Good call.
Aaron Glenn had an interception last week against Stanford. Played that one well, but forgot to hang on to the ball. First down and 10 at the 45. Luke, play action, Buckley in his face. What a catch by Odell Beckham. And he got drilled by Patrick Bates.
You know, the book on Beckham is that he's a good receiver. And they're trying to throw to him more. He adds quickness and depth. He was a starting tailback, and now they move him over to fullback. Now watch this. Here comes Odell Beckham. Watch this. One-hand grab, pulls it in. Story too. Not only is he a quality player, watch him bang here. He gets the best of the league. But here's a guy that was Prop 48, which is academic. Then he got the Coach's Scholastic Award as the best achiever in school. Great score.
And this time it's Robert Davis's turn. Bounces it outside. The freshman from Alabama down to the 31-yard line.
Robert Davis carries.
Statistically, it was A&M in the first half of play, 229 total yards to LSU's 180.
Well, LSU was able to throw the ball. A&M was able to pass the ball. And the discrepancy in total offense is not that great. The big thing there to me is the fact that out of the first 30 minutes, A&M had it almost 20.
And only had a 7-point lead to show for it. Backside of the eye for LSU. Luke with the fake to the back. Jacob complete down to the 9-yard line. Wesley Jacob with a pickup of 21 yards, and Luke drilled it in.
Not only that, but Luke makes his play work. Watch Luke. Great play action here, and then pulls up. The cornerback on that side, Glenn, took the fake. He rolled up. Wesley went by him. And there is the big, big play. 21 yards.
Much like Granger last week, Loop with a chance to watch things from the sideline in that second quarter seems to have regained his composure now.
Nice play by Loop and Jacob.
First down. Davis, the freshman, getting the J-O-B-D-O-N-E down to the 4-yard line. Jason Atkinson with a tackle.
Now it's that LSU line firing out. And A&M looks tired. Mawai, Landry, Gottfried all got good blocks that time. How about this?
Boy, you know, you watch the substitution pattern by Curly Holman. It's like a power play unit in hockey, watching the players come in and out.
And R.C. Slocum's got to be wondering, what the heck is happening here? Number one defense in the country, and they're moving on us.
Oh, you don't need a delay
too much time again. Do not need a delay a game penalty there.
That might be the third time this afternoon. I have to wonder what exactly is causing the problem here.
Well, look at Curly Holman's telling Luke, hey, use your eyes. Look down there. There is the clock. The play got right in front of you in the end zone. Look for it. It's a seventh penalty against his ball club.
This one coming at a critical time as well.
Now I'm wondering, too, if those plays aren't coming in a little bit late.
Second down and goal. It's pushed back to 10 now. Max in the offset eye. Blitzing. Here's Davis up the middle. Touchdown, LSU.
Message for you. This kid's a freshman. He's got 124 yards and 12 carries. And look at him. He's a talent. that Hill's not, because he is. But how about this?
Robert Davis, hey, do you think he wants to hold on to that starting job?
Highly recruited. They say he doesn't have great speed.
Suarez with the extra point, and guess what? Hey, we got a tie ball game. Give us a break and come back.
All cars are made with sheets of metal. But one of these sheets is actually a sandwich of steel, resin, and steel, used by Lexus to help quiet the cabin of the LS400. Care to guess which one?
When you've got a tough case of athlete's foot, the itching, the cracking, the burning, you want a medicine that acts tough. Tough-actin, tenactin.
Clinically proven tenactin cures even the tough cases of athlete's foot fungus. Get tough-actin, tenactin.
Hitachi. Oh, wait, that's my phone.
I'll connect you now.
Bonjour, here are the drawings.
Looks good from here.
Hello.
Okay, thanks.
Goodbye.
Take care.
Au revoir.
Hitachi makes digital communication systems and 20,000 other amazing products. Hitachi.
I'd do anything for my baby. Anything for my baby.
You're nuts about nougat, crazy for caramel, and absolutely wild about peanuts. You'd do anything for a baby Ruth.
Anything for my baby, anything for my baby. Baby Ruth.
Number one, Miami, defends their national title against Big Ten power Iowa. Tonight on ABC Sports.
Cooking in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Deadlocked at 14 between LSU and Texas A&M. This is Ray Mickens, 5 yards deep. And he'll take it on the 20 instead.
They always tell offensive linemen to stay with clocks. I want you to watch 73 Sidnick, and he's working on Eric England, number 92. Stays with him, pushes him back, touchdown. Davis.
Acadian Ambulance Service urges you to drive safely when leaving the game.
Davis, not a big guy. Goes only a buck 87. But running strong near the goal line. Carter and Hill. The backs. And the thrill is dumped. A game of about three by Rodney Young, the strong safety. Rodney's been a big part of that LSU defense today.
That was an outstanding play there. He came up, supported the run, took on the blocker, got off the blocker, came back and made the tackle.
Approaching the 10-minute mark to play in the third quarter.
Yeah!
And this crowd is back in the game. No question. Buckles coming. Off the hill, and he has a gain of about 2 yards.
Buckles made that tackle too. That was an interesting thing. They brought him off the corner. And they had the safety Young come over and roll up and take the outside receiver.
Hill carries, tackled by Bo Davis.
Well, Greg Hill was talking the talk, but so far it's Davis walking the walk so far.
Keep in mind it was Greg Hill who said, I can get 150, 100, 200 yards against anybody. But look, the freshman comes in and he's the one banging out the yardage.
Third down and four. And here come the Bayou Bengals on the blitz. And Granger smartly picks it up and hits the receiver, Carter.
Granger pass is complete.
Boy, they were bringing everybody on that play, Tim.
First down for the Aggies.
Just a little late and a first down for A&M.
I think you said it best. He picked up the blitz and released it quickly. Knew he was going to get hit, still made the complete.
Got the first. Play action. Going over the middle, has his tight end open, but he overthrows McKeon.
This has been a solid day for Granger, but he has missed some open guys. He's now 10 for 20.
But he split the seam, brings his tight end down the middle. He's behind everybody, and all you have to do is get to him. Even if you throw it behind him, just lob it up there and let him wait. He still pick up the yardage for the first, and then if you get it there quickly enough, then he can pick up a lot more.
His motion does look a little better today, though. Coaches talked earlier about him being mechanically a little bit off in that Stanford game, throwing across his body. Second down and 10, Hill. It's his time. Greg Hill into LSU territory, down to the 46-yard line, tackled by Young. A 23-yard pickup.
Young saved another touchdown.
Rodney Young.
And he wants a break. See him holding up his hand right there? That's to the coaches saying, hey, I need a breather. I'm tired. Hill almost breaks this one. Watch this great cut to the outside and gets the block out there from Harrison. And then Young gets him by the jersey just enough to pull him down.
One of the few times today, Tim, that we've seen that explosiveness from Hill.
If I'm offensively, I'd go right back at Young. He's really sucking wind right now. He wants a break, and they won't give it to him.
Still pulling on his jersey. Backs out of the eye this time. Play action, and
he's still got the football.
Granger with a great fake going to Matthews. Touchdown, A&M, no, incomplete. He couldn't hang on. Vincent Fuller breaking the play up along with Carlton Buckles. did Granger have everyone fooled or what?
I'll tell you this. He not only had the defense fooled, but he threw a strike here. Watch this. Play action. Watch the ball right behind him. Now watch how cool he is. Just wait, wait. Hey, guys, where's that ball? Who's got it? Well, there goes my receiver splitting the seam. I better hit him now. Steps up, and he really drills it. Should have been caught. It was a perfect throw.
Boy, great ball handling that time by Granger. Remind me of another left-hander, Boomer Esiason on that one.
Maryland guy.
Oh, yeah. You had to tell me. Under pressure, and he's not going to escape this time.
Rivero Swan.
Swan shaking off injuries this year, staying healthy, and making a big play right there, a loss of 10 yards.
Talked to the coaches, asked for a little synopsis on each player. We got the Swan. The only thing they said was, he's big time.
Enough said.
R.C. Slocum, one of my favorite coaches in the country. Folks, he's going after a national title. Consistently, he's up near the top.
He's taken his team to a bowl game in each of his first 3 years as head coach. Talk about a guy paying his dues. R.C. Slocum as an assistant coach. 16 years as an assistant at A&M.
Not only that, but Texas A&M has had the Southwest Conference Player of the Year for the last 6 years. Kevin Murray, Darren Lewis, Bucky Richardson. Just to name a couple of them. Plus, every starting linebacker he's ever had has gotten a shot to play in the NFL.
Linebacker U of the South, Bucky Richardson, interestingly enough, making the Houston Oilers.
You know, I did that game a couple of weeks ago between the Cowboys and the Oilers up in Irving at Texas Stadium. And he came in, and they were down. He led the touchdown drive in the last few seconds and won it as the clock expired.
All right, now let's go to New York and John Saunders with this update. John?
Notre Dame and Northwestern. The Irish was tight for a while, but now trying to break it open. Rick Meyer across to Mike Miller, who's wide open and races to the end zone. 70 yards, 21-7 now. The Irish with the lead. Back to Mark.
Rick Meyer maybe padding his stats a little bit, looking at the Heisman Trophy.
I don't think he's looking at the Heisman Trophy. I think a lot of other people are looking at it for him. He certainly is one of the top-rated Heisman candidates. I still like Eric Zier down at Georgia, just a sophomore, but he's as good as I've seen.
And movement along the A&M offensive line. It looked like it was number 67 that time, Jason Matthews. Pulled up a little early. And listen to the crowd.
Rocket and rolling in Baton Rouge. Showing the blitz, hiding the blitz, got everybody excited. Consequently, Jason Matthews, the right tackle, got too excited and jumped and moved.
Third down and a cab ride. all day for Granger. Wide open. That's Matthews. And he's down at the 25, and guess what? He got the first down. Have to wonder how that could happen. A pickup of 36 yards. I've heard of a prevent defense, but that was ridiculous. They had no pressure on him.
Don't get confused. We are in Baton Rouge, but A&M brought an awful lot of fans.
Zone coverage. How does somebody get behind a zone? They split the field in thirds, and obviously nobody took the backside right third. You saw White, 54, the linebacker was up, but there was no cornerback back there to help out. The ball on the 25, first and 10. Toss to the backfield, that's Hill, and he's tripped up. A nice play that time by Daryl McCorvey, the strong safety, one of the few players that came up to make the tackle. Good penetration that time by the Tigers.
He actually tripped over his own man, 81, Ryan Matthews. And Matthews now asking to go out and does, gets a breather. He was just tired, almost fell down right in front of Hill.
A lot of players down there sucking wind.
90 degrees
in the shade
and humid
in the shade. 6:50 to play in the third quarter. Tie ball game. More play action by Granger. Looking for the tight end, and it's this time it's ruled interception. Daryl McCorvey, two plays in a row. And LSU takes over the ball. We're going to take a break. Stick around.
Oil. It's the lifeblood of your engine. That makes your oil filter your engine's most vital organ. That's why Fram keeps going the extra mile to make the best protection even better. The Fram Extra Guard Oil Filter. Unique glass fiber paper stops more dirt than any other filter for the best protection ever. Fram Extra Guard. American or import, it's an extra lease on life.
Every business morning, while the rest of the world is getting up, UPS is guaranteeing overnight delivery before 10:30. For far less than other companies charge. And every business morning, more people are waking up to that fact.
Good morning.
Morning.
Since its introduction, umpteen commercials ago, the Lexus LS400 has been hailed by car magazines, raved over by critics, and praised by owners in survey after survey. Which just goes to show that some of the most powerful advertising is the kind you don't have to pay for.
Defensively, LSU comes up with a big play. Number one, Granger tries to make a pass he shouldn't. He throws into coverage and tries to force it in there. That's the first thing. And the LSU Tigers get the pick. Now McCorvey comes up, makes the interception. Here's a guy who's playing with a bad hamstring. He had an interception last year, makes the big play here and stops the drive. And Granger knows he shouldn't have thrown it.
Any way you slice it, it's first and 10 Tigers on their own 14-yard line. That's Jermaine Williams.
It's going to be holding against LSU, though. Look more like a scrum in rugby.
Jermaine Williams carry. Grant made the tackle.
He'll bring this one back. Well, what better way to enjoy your Labor Day Monday? Join us for the season premiere of ABC's Monday Night Football. One of the classic rivalries in all of sports, Redskins against the Cowboys.
Talked about the Cowboys, Casillas is out, Russell Maryland's banged up, probably won't play, but the Redskins have had a rough preseason as well. They went over to London, they came back, they moved into New Redskin Park. It's been very disruptive, and Desmond Howard was holding out, Rippon held out.
My favorite Monday night game, Cowboys-Redskins, Walt Garrison held by Kenny Houston on the last play of the game to save the game for the Redskins. Beckham and Butler lined up in the eye for the Tigers. This is Butler, the freshman. Not much room over that right side. A&M defense maybe turning it up a notch. The stop by Steve Solari.
Solari made the tackle.
Transfer out of Purdue.
Solari is a man. I'm telling you, he knows the difference between come here and sick him. Came up, tucked his tail, and drove right through his chin.
Carolina's going to have a good football team this year. See the scores.
Southern Miss, Curley's old school.
Second down and 12. Handoff again to the freshman, Butler. He's on close to the 20. Stopped at the 19-yard line that time. The tackle made by the quarterback, Aaron Glenn. Glenn had an interception just a few moments ago, but then fumbled it. LSU got the ball back.
5:14 remaining in the third quarter. Now, LSU wanted to get this down to a one-quarter football game. They wanted to play 15 minutes, and let's be even, and we'll take it from there playing at home. So far, 14-14, you can't beat it.
Texas A&M has lost its last three games here in Death Valley. Here they come with the blitz. And Luke gets it off complete to Besh, and he's out to the 30. And that should be a first down, a pickup of 11 yards. Tackled by Glenn. Good play selection that time by LSU.
Call this Death Valley. It's always been one of the toughest tickets to get. Look, top of your screen there, you'll see some empty seats. That's unheard of in LSU history. But a couple of losing seasons, and now they keep playing like this against Texas A&M like they are. It'll bring the folks back into the stadium.
And put the spark back in that love affair. Wesley Jacob in motion for LSU. Hand off to Butler. I kind of like Curley Holman's idea, Tim, of really rotating in a lot of the freshmen. Get them some good playing time, get some experience because, hey, next year they turn into sophomores and you got to use them.
You saw the expression on my face when we started talking about rotating first and second teams. I said, hey, wait a minute. Coach, you were 5-6 last year. You didn't have that much talent. What are you doing playing these guys? He says, we're going to keep them fresh. We've recruited well. They're young. They need experience. He did it at Southern Miss. Can't question him now. It's working.
Yeah, he won games that way at Southern Miss. Second down and 8. The deep back. That's Johnson out over the 35 to the 36, tackled by Reggie Graham. Graham, hey, how'd you like to be him and fill in for the shoes of a guy named Quentin Coriant, maybe?
It's a big task. It is a big play, but to me, that's one of the things that really makes this defensive A&M special. Watch him come up and make the hit. That, folks, will rattle your feelings. But the thing about, you're talking about Quentin Coriant, they also lost Kevin Smith, number one draft pick playing for the Dallas Cowboys. Take two first rounders out of there, and you're still solid as a rock.
Just reload, and here they come with the blitz. Buckley with the pressure, and a flag down as the pass falls incomplete intended for Jesse Daigle, the backup quarterback.
Smart play by Luke to get rid of the football, but I think what they're going to call here is holding against LSU.
Well, it's not called holding. It's called saving your quarterback's neck.
It is against LSU. That came from the umpire. He threw it right into the big pile up there.
Buckley with great penetration and pressure that time.
Which is declined fourth down.
Now, they say Marcus Buckley is only 80%, but he looks a lot more than 80 to me. Now, Tim, if you're that man, Curley Holman, what do? Do you stay with Loop? Or do you do like what you did in the first half? You switch to Huffman?
I think he would be the first one to tell you that it is a feel. When he has a feeling that it's time to change, he will. Both quarterbacks now being productive.
Marcellus into punt again. Frazier will catch this one on his own 30 and running. Derek Frazier's dangerous. He's out to the 44-yard line. 34-yard punt, 14 yards on the return. It's a tie game.
It has four independent motors, an intricate steel frame, even an electronically regulated temperature control system. And that's just the driver's seat. The Lexus ES300 luxury sedan.
got a bit of an edge with the driver we have. We've got the best driver out there. So it's a matter of the mechanics just not overlooking anything. Al and I stay in constant communication during the race. I have to be aware of what he wants or needs, you know, at all times. I think the small details are is what makes the difference between winning and running second.
At the first tickly itch of athlete's foot, that's an X. Killing those grungy fungi before they get racket and burning. Go get that can now, or else don't blame Desinex.
Hitachi? Actually, I'm kind of busy right now working on a big project.
Hitachi makes computer systems and 20,000 other intelligent products. Hitachi.
Well, we asked Hudson Corley-Coleman how he felt about taking on his alma mater, Texas A&M. This is what he had to say.
Anytime an individual or an institution or a group, they give you an opportunity to better yourself, a chance to be successful in life, Texas A&M gave me that opportunity in 1965 when no other university would do it. Coach Stallings and the staff there, they said, here's an opportunity. Be a player, be a student, do the things you're supposed to as a person, and take care of your business.
And that's exactly what they've been doing today, taking care of business. First and 10, Greg Hill for A&M out to the 47-yard line. Right now, let's go to New York and John Saunders.
The Fighting Irish of Notre Dame starting to bust it open against Northwestern, and bust it open is appropriate as you watch Jerome Bettis here just romp and rumble into the end zone, 24 yards, his 14 carries for 112 yards. Mark.
Jerome looked like a runaway train on that. 14-14 back here. Second down and 7. Ranger to pass. As the receiver open at midfield down to the 46-yard line. Tony Harrison with the reception. Tony Harrison, the leading receiver on this Aggie team last year. Well, tomorrow on ABC Sports, the big guns of the PGA Tour will be shooting for the title. Join us at 4 Eastern, 3 Central and Pacific for the final round coverage of the Greater Milwaukee Open, presented by Sharps, tomorrow on ABC. Hill and Thomas in the backfield. The give is to Thomas. Nice agility with the legs, jumping over a couple of tacklers out to the 32, a pickup of 14 yards before finally being tackled by Ivory Hilliard.
Another LSU player down and injured. This looks like Steptoe. Thomas, you know, Hill has not been able to get it done. He's gone in spurts today, but he still has not been able to break it. Every time it looks like he's going to break it, he'll pick up a gain, and they're pulling down from behind. So Thomas comes in. Rodney Thomas is fresh and gets the big gain.
And we've seen R.C. Slocum a couple times today, on a few occasions, actually, go with both Thomas and Hill in the backfield.
There's a look at Mike Steptoe, the right cornerback who was hurt. One of the few players who was moved from offense to defense. He was a tailback last year. Vincent Fuller also was a tailback. He's now playing safety. So what they did is they took some of their best talent and put it on the defense. And they had to. Their defense last year was porous.
That is, in essence, college football. Right?
Yes,
guys going two ways. Anthony Williams playing tight end and linebacker for LSU. Jesse Daigle playing wide receiver as well as backup quarterback.
23, Memphis State, 21.
Well, at this time, we'd like to pause 5 seconds and allow our ABC stations to identify themselves.
Alabama 25, Vanderbilt 8. In the third quarter, once again, Notre Dame 14, Northwestern.
Beautiful day in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, nothing but blue skies.
This is a bad sign here. They're bringing out a temporary cast. They're bringing out a mobile gurney-type wheelchair-type thing. And Steptoe will be taken off on that. As far as Curley Holman and his LSU team, this has been a tremendous performance, even though they have had quite a few mistakes this afternoon. It's been a gutsy performance. And if you look ahead, the Tigers play seven games here in Baton Rouge. Seven games. But A&M, Mississippi State, Auburn, Tennessee, University of Florida, five of those teams are in the first six. So you can see it's not an easy schedule by any stretch of the imagination. This is what happened last year. You saw they got off to those two losses right away. But this year, seven of their games are here in Baton Rouge.
And that's got to help in this maybe the toughest conference in all of college football, the SEC. Vamp this year, have the East and the West Division of Arkansas comes in. And of course, they've added a championship game December the 5th in Birmingham.
And what a South show Carolina, that's, right. That's exactly right. Alabama favored in the West, Florida favored in the East.
A lot of eyes going to be on that championship game. See how that works out. The toss to the deep back, that's Thomas. He's inside the 30 to the 28 with 1:27 remaining in the third quarter. Thomas now with nine rushes for 38 yards on the day.
More importantly, too, A&M starting to grind this thing out. You know, before this drive, they had the ball only 4 minutes in this quarter, and the LSU defense had done a nice job of keeping it away from them, where they had it almost 20 of the first 30. But anyway, they got it going now, and Thomas has been the catalyst. He's the guy. High step in his way, going around the corners.
Now Tim Carter and Hill in the backfield. Handoff is to Hill. I think it's a safe bet. I'm not a betting man, but I think it's a safe bet to say that it doesn't look like he's going to get his 150 team.
I don't know if I
no disrespect it. No disrespect, Greg.
He's got 14 carries, 68 yards. I wouldn't bet again. He could break an 80-yarder any time. Not from here, obviously.
Well, at that point, I'll just jump back on the bandwagon.
Ricardo Washington made that tackle. There's a guy that was also moved over from tight end.
Third and five. The blitz. He gets rid of it, and it's incomplete. Tony Harrison had it, but it was knocked loose by the defender, Ray Adams. Let's go back to New York with John Saunders.
The USC and San Diego State, who else but Marshall Faulk, 11 yards for the touchdown. He has 17 carries for 107 yards. Eighth time in his career, he's been over 100. Let's get it back to you.
And speaking of great young players, Marshall Faulk. Is he ever? Oh, man. Terry Venetoulias in, 44-yard attempt. They get it down, and he's got the leg, and he splits the uprights. This guy has been clutch. Long of his career, he puts it through and gives Texas A&M the lead. Last week against Stanford, he put the dagger in their hearts. And right now, he gives Texas A&M a three-point lead. Good snap, good hold, gets his whole leg into it.
Well, I'll tell you this. Terry Venetoulias, he led the Southwest Conference in scoring, 72% percentage. And he gives him the advantage here. I'll tell you what I want to do now. Let's kick off. Let's watch the 12th man. Let's see how he does. Trent Bishop. 12th man, it's a tradition which was started by Jackie Sherrill. He just took 12 students out of his student body and made them the kickoff team. And finally, A&M wised up, and he said, wait a minute. Let's just put one guy out there and give him a shot. So Trent Bishop, there he is, number 12. Actually goes back to Dana X Bible in those days when they pulled a guy out of the stands when everybody got banged up, and he played well, won the ball game. So they kept the tradition alive. We'll keep an eye on him this time.
Part of the great tradition of college football. David Butler is back deep along with Gary Pegues. They only carry one 12th man traditionally, but there have been occasions where some 12th men have jumped in their own cars and driven to the game and dress up and play. This is Butler, and LSU will have to take it on its own 20.
Bishop got untouched. He was ready to run up into the stands. Look at him. He's slapping everybody five. He's happy. Oh, that's exactly right. Nobody got a hand on him. He ran down, got in the game. There is a flag down.
Hey, guy's got to work up a lather, right?
Watch this. Here comes Trent Bishop. Watch. Nobody even gets near him. I'm going to get there. Now, the other guys are running by him, right?
No, that's just a bad picture. He's fast.
That's funny. Trent Bishop, more power to him. And the 12th man, let him live forever. College football.
We've got 13 seconds to go in the third quarter.
as the officials are discussing the call down on the field. You know, talking about the 12th man and that tradition, Jackie Sherrill, now head coach of Mississippi State, that's who LSU takes on next week.
Grab holding during the kickoff. The penalty is declined. First down.
Look at Dick Burleson now. He's been working the whole game on that mic. He's been trying to switch the thing. He finally got it to work. Finally figured out after three quarters how to get that microphone to work.
Oh, we're getting used to reading his lips.
Those guys doing a good job.
First and 10, Beckham and Jermaine Williams in the backfield behind Chad Loop. He sat down for a while in the second quarter. Huffman came on, and here's the halfback option. Incomplete for Wesley Jacob.
Odell Beckham's done it all today. You know, he was the tailback. They moved him to fullback. Now they run the option pass to him. He tries to throw it. Pretty good arm, too. Boy, it's a strong arm. Threw it about 50 yards. Unfortunately, the receiver was at about 30 yards.
Curley going into his little bag of tricks this time.
Look at this. Actually, it wasn't that bad. It was about 10 yards in front of him.
Yeah, Aaron Glenn with tremendous coverage that time, though. Buckley on a blitz. Beckham with the handoff up to the 25. And that will be the end of a tough third quarter of play. We'll return with more action between Texas A&M and LSU after this message and a word from our ABC station.
Today, a woman needs a life insurance plan of her own.
State Farm sells life insurance from an agent who's there for you today and there tomorrow, too. You see, we start you outright with a plan specifically designed for a woman's needs, one that protects the people who count on you for so very much. And the State Farm agent will be there tomorrow, too, as your life changes, to keep that plan working for the people you love.
State Farm sells life insurance.
This vehicle has a number of features that make it an extremely secure place to put money. So does this one. A Lexus LS400. With the highest retained value in its class, it's like money in the bank.
I'm Oprah Winfrey. Join me for an emotional, sometimes shocking hour that can help save lives and families. Watch Scared Silent, Sunday on ABC.
$1,000 cash back on all full-size pickups during your Houston area Ford dealer's factory authorized clearance. With cash back, that means the Texas Special Edition F-150 comes with savings of more than $3,300. And this pickup has all the most popular equipment, plus air conditioning and automatic at no extra charge. Save over $3,300 on a full-size Ford pickup during the factory authorized clearance at your Houston area Ford dealer.
They've devoted their lives to kids without hope. Next, Geraldo.
We're back in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Mark Jones along with Tim Brandt in the house. Week one of college football here on ABC. And what a fantastic game so far. A&M leading LSU 17-14. Chad Loop gets rid of it, and it's picked off. Derek Frazier, the corner, comes up and catches the proverbial dead duck.
Well, they say he doesn't make many bad decisions, but that one right there was terrible.
He was backing up. He was under pressure. He was off balance. Throw the ball away. You don't want to take the sacks or throw it away. Just throw it at his feet. They threw it right to him. Hung it out there.
Tim, the first turnover today by LSU and a costly one. Look where they give it up.
They have to watch Luke here. All right, here comes the pressure. He stumbles. So now he's going to backpedal. He's off balance. Pressure's still coming. Throw it off his heels. He knew it was interception. See him start to run as soon as he let it go. Knew it was picked off.
Can they capitalize, A&M? Granger hands it off to Rodney Thomas. Take it in the house. 22 yards on the score. Two plays making a world of difference in this football game. Venatulius with the extra point to make it 24-14, and Chad Loop wishes he could have just one pass back.
It's the weekend, and the Honda Automobile plant in Marysville, Ohio is closed. Everybody's gone home. Well, almost everybody. So, this is a good time to show you around. 10,000 Americans build 3 out of every 5 Hondas sold in America right here in Ohio. Did you know that? Well, we won't take up any more of your time. After all, it is the weekend.
Change. There is one certainty. The financial strength of the Prudential. Rock solid in securities, insurance, and real estate. Each day, all over the country, nothing satisfies so many people in so many ways. Beef. It's what's for dinner.
The defending Super Bowl champion Washington Redskins face their arch rival, the Dallas Cowboys. It's the season premiere of ABC's Monday Night Football this week.
Back for the kickoff in the fourth quarter. Just underway here in the fourth quarter. Venatulius kicking it off. Butler and Pegues back deep for LSU. This is the freshman Butler. A big return earlier in the second quarter, but this time down at the 24-yard line for Tim. Chad Luke's turnover very costly. No question about it. Terrible decision on his part. Frazier makes the pickoff. And then Thomas runs it in for the touchdown to break this thing open for the time being. Watch this now. Here comes Thomas. They've got him down mentally because they just picked off the pass. And now here comes Thomas, not touched until he gets to the 15 and breaks that in the secondary. But I've got to be wondering what the heck has happened to Ryan Huffman, the quarterback for LSU. Came in at everything he could, and they're going back with Loop.
Loop on the option gives it to the freshman Robert Davis, who, by the way, has been conspicuously silent since the second quarter in that big run.
There's number 15. There's Huffman. Ryan Huffman, redshirt freshman. He comes in when LSU's not doing anything offensively. He goes 1 for 2, 16 yards. He rushes 2 times, 7 yards, touchdown, moved him up and down the field. What else can he do?
Well, whatever the case, it's Loop. Besh in motion. Loop hands it off to Davis. Sidesteps one tackler out to the 32. Pickup of about 3 on that play.
Davis carry. Jackson and England made the tackle for the Aggies.
Boy, they used to say just send money, huh? College.
Economic tough times, recession. Just say hi now.
Play here for LSU. 3rd and 1. Got to hang on to the ball.
and there was a mix-up in the backfield. Loop hung on to it, and he sacked for loss.
I don't think it was a mix-up. I think they were going to run the option. They faked to the fullback straight up the middle, but, I mean, he was stonewalled. And when he got hung up, then Loop tripped over his feet. Watch this. Here comes the first fake, all right? Boom. He gets stonewalled there and then trips over everybody's feet. Oh, I want to tell you something. England was coming in and pushed everybody into the backfield. He's 6'3", 264, acted like he was 300.
Derek Frazier, the guy that made the big kick just a few moments ago, catching this punt. And he's brought down at the 37-yard line, 39-yard punt, and five on the return. Chris Watermeyer making the tackle.
On the tackle.
A&M with a 10-point lead.
All right.
A great man once said, winning, gentlemen, isn't everything. It's the only thing.
Look, a grasshopper!
I formation, 34 sweep on two. Got it? Just give the ball to Matt. Tell me one for today. Got it?
It starts every September with teams like the Turkey Creek Hawks, the Bronx Eagles, and the Newport Richie Giants. On fields where dads aren't only coaches, and oak trees mark the end zones. And a good day isn't determined by if you win or lose, but where you go after the game. So McDonald's would like to salute the players, the coaches, the families, everyone who helped make this season a perfect season.
Can you go to McDonald's now, Coach?
After the game, Lenny. This is only halftime. Go sit down.
Presenting the new Civic Del Sol from Honda. It's a sporty open-top car with a very remarkable feature. When it's windy outside, it's not so windy inside.
Backup quarterback Ryan Huffman warming up with Jesse Daigle, also a backup quarterback on the sidelines. Tim, good bet to see him next series.
No question in my mind. Huffman will be back in the ballgame.
And this is Greg Hill out to the 41. Hill tackled that time by Corey White. Now, we've been talking about Hill a lot throughout the afternoon, and you know his prediction that he was going to run for between 150 and 200 yards, but combined with Rodney Thomas, that has been one heck of a two-headed running monster.
Oh, it is. He's got 73 yards. That's nothing to really laugh at. He's a quality back. Set the Southwest Conference freshman running back record last year. Previously held by Earl Campbell.
Tough the second time around, though. Tougher. Team's looking out for you. Here he comes again, though. Greg Hill starting to show something. Into LSU territory, down to the 48-yard line, a pickup of 10, and a first down for the Aggies. Rovell Rose Swan on the tackle.
First down for the Aggies.
See, now you're betting against this guy. He's got 83 yards now, and if he pops one, look out. He's going to get you. Whole line slants. Everybody pulls down. He cuts back against the grain and gets the pickup. See, now if LSU gets down on itself and figures the game's lost for a while, he could pop one.
We've got 12:20 to play in the fourth quarter. Reveille's happy. Number five. And his counterpart, Mike the fifth, the Bengal Tiger, somewhere within the vicinity. Stay tuned for the Car Rental post-game report, featuring scores and highlights from across the country. A very busy day on this first full weekend of college football. Of course, a big game tonight coming up involving the number one ranked Miami Hurricanes. They're in Iowa City to take on the Hawkeyes. Texas A&M next week, they go back to Kyle Field to meet the Tulsa Northern Hurricanes. LSU, meanwhile, takes on Mississippi State.
Got a good look at the Texas A&M Fighting Texas Aggie Band. Celebrating its centennial year, 1994.
Let's look at A&M's schedule coming up. Tulsa, they try to avenge their only defeat of the regular season last year. And they travel to Missouri. They'll take on the Tigers. Lubbock, Texas to take on Texas Tech. Sharp and McKeon, a couple of tight ends in now for A&M. Greg Hill. Ball's loose. Great balance, a fumble, and LSU says they have it and they do. Daryl McCorby made the fumble recovery. A&M with its third turnover of the afternoon. This could put the door open, leave the door open for LSU.
Hill cuts to the outside here where he trips over his own man and has the helmet actually come up from underneath and knock it out. Look who's back in the ballgame. It's Huffman coming in at quarterback.
Hill has been haunted by fumbles back in the Cotton Bowl against Florida State. He fumbled the ball three times. Ball out to the 42-yard line. The freshman Robert Davis on the carry. Tackled by Eric England.
Didn't get much yardage on it, but I'll tell you this. Lance Teitelman knew that he came in there. He ended up on the seat of his pants.
And Ryan Huffman back in at quarterback. Davis and Beckham in the offset eye. Little play action by Huffman. And it's almost picked off.
Jason Atkinson stood up and got a hand on it.
Keefe Chatham also there. Nice play action, but he couldn't deliver the ball.
Davis now 15 carries, 134 yards. Now Daigle comes into the ball game as a receiver. It's that point of the ball game where I would not be surprised if they tried something fancy. Maybe almost like a pass out to Daigle and let Daigle throw. Daigle would be the inside receiver in the trips formation.
And here they come with the blitz. Huffman looking for the hot receiver. Daigle catches it at the 45-yard line. It's complete. And Patrick Bates touched him down. Good awareness that time by the quarterback, Ryan Huffman.
Fourth down for the Tigers.
That's what he did as a quarterback last year.
He started five games. Luke started the other six.
Derek Frazier.
Defense yelling, look out for the fake, but they're going to try to punt it, pooch it down inside the 20.
Sells with a nice boot over Frazier's head. Will they get to it? Uh-uh.
It'll
be A&M on the 20 after that 54-yard punt. Still a 10-point lead for the Aggies.
Our competition uses a very sophisticated, state-of-the-art, highly precise device to measure their cars. Our car, the Accord from Honda.
Changes, there is one certainty. The financial strength of the Prudential, rock solid in securities, insurance, and real estate.
The scenery is majestic. Your camera is poised. You're struck by the beauty of the mountain, and then you're struck by the mountain. Why risk your camera when you can use ours? Fuji QuickSnap, one-time use cameras.
Witter believes every investor's success story is unique. From getting in on the ground floor to getting all the way to the top, Dean Witter can help you make it every step of the way.
We measure success one investor at a time.
R.C. Slocum watching from the sidelines. His team with a 10-point bulge so far in the fourth quarter. The ball is on the ground.
LSU recovers it.
Oh, no. That was down caused by the ground. The ground can't cause a fumble, so they're going to give it to Texas A&M.
Listening for the whistle there. Young and Ravelro Swan making the hit.
And Young made the tackle.
But it'll stay A&M ball.
Never really did get a good handle on it. Look, he still doesn't have the tip of the ball tucked in. Well, I'll tell you what, Ivory Hilliard may have knocked that thing loose before his back hit.
Granger hands it off to Thomas. Mucho room, lots of room. Out to the 39-yard line, a pickup of 13 and a first down for the Aggies.
12 carries, 79 yards for Thomas now. I mean, he explodes around that corner.
You know, Greg Hill is a fantastic player, an all-conference player, but you know, Rodney Thomas isn't that far behind, and he's proving it this afternoon. Rodney Young now, the injured player for the Tigers.
You know, offensive coordinator Bob Toledo of Texas A&M, he thought about going to the 49ers. Says, well, I got nine starters back from a 10-2 team. I got two running backs like Hill and Thomas. Maybe it's not a bad deal to stay here.
That's good career planning. You don't need a career planner to tell you that. Huh?
There's Bob Toledo. Looks like he's been out there playing.
One thing we haven't seen from the Aggies this afternoon is the swinging gate play, which they like to use sometimes.
Yeah, you won't see that until later on down the road here.
Yeah, they're trick plays. Handoff out to the 40-yard line that time on first down and 10. Bo Thomas Davis Garrett making the tackle.
Bo Davis tackled him.
9.5 minutes remaining. The clock winding down on LSU.
Time definitely becomes a factor now, trailing by 10, but the game certainly still has plenty of time to win this thing. I mean, LSU does. They've still got to be patient, but
Granger, unlike last week, going from the opening gun. Last week he sat out parts of the third quarter before returning for the fourth quarter. Now he steps back and calls a timeout.
That was a smart play, too. He called that timeout with 1 second left on the play clock, so he was facing. See, that's what he's telling him now. Hey, Coach Toledo. See, that thing was down to one. If I don't call that timeout, we get penalized
again. Had LSU done that a couple times this afternoon, they would have been in better field position, maybe have a few more points on the board.
Well, let me say this. They do have a 10-point lead, but there's still 9 minutes left in this game, and by getting the team out late, coming up and having to call that timeout, Texas A&M now has no time. So if this becomes a tight-fit ball game, that's going to come back and haunt them.
Well, if you just turned on your television set and tuned in our game, I'll tell you that earlier, a few times during the course of the afternoon, LSU has been hit with delay of game penalties, not getting the playoff in time. Gorgeous afternoon here in Cajun country. Louisiana State University saw Billy Cannon, great Heisman Trophy winner. Saw him last night. And here's a look at the brand new SEC, revamped, redone, reworked.
Well, that certainly is the most notable change in a year in college football when there have been so many. South Carolina and Arkansas creating the two-division system and also bringing in the rich playoff game by having 12 teams in there now.
That's not going to hurt the pocketbooks either. This is Rodney Thomas spinning off a couple of tackles out to the 43. Rodney Thomas has been extremely busy this afternoon, and so has Greg Hill. Still trying to pay off on his prediction to run for between 150 and 200 yards.
White.
And so far, maybe he's about halfway there.
Well, maybe if we can combine the two.
Yeah, but he didn't say that, his prediction.
No, as a matter of fact, he said Thomas was going to run for 100 to 150.
L.M. Carter in the backfield. Granger over the middle, wide open to his tight end, Greg Short. Short, last week's MVP against Stanford, and here coming up with a grab for the first down.
Oh, he is a quality player. Had 4 receptions last week, opening night, showtime. They didn't go to their tight end that much last year, but they've made an effort to go to the tight end more often now. Here's a guy, 6'3", 233 pounds, and runs like a tailback. He's out of San Antonio. Quality player.
So far, a quality game for Texas A&M. They lead by 10.
with 8 minutes to play in the fourth quarter. Over midfield down to the 48, Swan with the tackle. Let's go back to New York and John Saunders.
He'll carry it.
Seeing San Diego State, Rob Johnson, this will be his fourth touchdown pass of the day, and Johnny Morton, his third touchdown catch. That ties a school record. Let's get it back to you.
USC got it going. Boy, time definitely becomes a factor now in this ball game. You see it remaining 7:37. LSU trailing by 10. They've got to start tackling the football, stripping it. Still not time to panic yet.
You have to be impressed with the poise of quarterback Jeff Granger this afternoon.
Curley's been on the field as much as his players.
Well, but, hey,
they're going to tell him that, hey, coach, you've got to stay off the field.
A&M's got a 12th man. He wants to have one, too.
Greg Hill. No thrill, but a pickup of two. Tackled by Ravelro Swan.
He'll carry.
Greg Hill out of Dallas Carter High School. All right, this will bring up a third down and long. LSU has got to stop him here and get the ball back offensively.
To come with a blitz, good time to blitz or to lay back?
Well, if you do, it's got to be a controlled blitz. In other words, what I'm saying is you don't want to give away. They've got 8 yards to go. You don't want to put yourself in a man-to-man situation with the blitz if you don't have the cover guys.
And the backs are split behind Granger. And Carter takes it, and he'll have a first down and more. One man to beat, and Carter is down at the 17-yard line. Carlton Buckles made the tackle, but not before a 31-yard pickup by Carter.
I don't want to send everybody home, but I think that one locks it up for A&M. I think they go to 2-0 now. Mike Bugar, the defense, he knows he had the right defense called, and it was blown. Watch this. The guys just getting blocked, missing tackles. You cannot miss tackles. Walkup had a shot at him. Swan had a shot at him. Just came right off of it.
Well, Doug Carter has had a very good day today.
Make that tackle. You get the ball back. You got a shot to win this thing.
Ranger handing it off. Lots of room for Thomas, and he was met that time by Ivory Hilliard. Hilliard came up from his free safety spot and made a nice hit.
By Walkup and Hilliard.
This is a pretty good lick. I like this. This guy, Ivory Hillard, he's not that big, comes up, but I mean to tell you, anytime you get the ball carrier to stop in his tracks and go backwards, pretty good lick.
And that put them back team on the 12-yard line. Second down and four.
They'd like to have that Swan tackle back, or lack of tackle.
This is Clifford Gross. And he bowls over a man and scores the touchdown.
You know who he bowled over? Hilliard. Last time Hilliard delivered the lick, this time he took the lick.
They call it payback. And that makes it 30-14. We've got some Aggies here.
A lot of them.
We've got some people here from College Station. A few yell leaders. They've been doing the job off the field. The Aggies get it done on the field. Venetulius with the extra point to make it 31-14.
Presenting the new Civic Del Sol from Honda. It's a sporty open-top car with a very remarkable feature. When it's windy outside, it's not so windy inside.
I noticed a definite difference in the way they drive.
The Goodyear AquaTread All-Season Radio. Its advanced deep groove aqua channels water away as you drive.
Just like you're glued to the road. 60,000 mile guarantee.
Snow, wet, dry,
strong, secure.
Aqua Tread, only from Goodyear.
Gives me a feeling of Aquaman.
Another reason we say the best tires in the world have Goodyear written all over them.
I'd go to Goodyear immediately. I really would.
experience for women. Aspen, now.
The first tickly itch of athlete's foot gets an X. Killing those grungy fungi before they get racket and burning. Go get that can now, or else don't blame Desinex.
Back in Baton Rouge, Terry Venituli is going to kick it off deep to David Butler and Artie Moore. Yankees with a 17-point lead. This is Butler. Cutting back. And down at the 20-yard line.
You see Trent Bishop, the 12th man, almost had the play. Got down into position to make the tackle, and he just flew by him.
To see himself on the highlights tonight.
I tell you, it looked good, though. Here's the touchdown again. Carter just barreling his, or Gross, rather, just barreling his way down. Actually resembles Carter somewhat, doesn't he?
He's